This is Logan Seeley live with John from Cool FM as we're going to bring you two-way playoff football between your Willcox Cowboys and the Scottsdale Prep Academy Spartans here in Scottsdale, Arizona tonight. And this broadcast is going to be brought to you by Mills Tire and Tech, family-owned since 2010. Owner Brian Mills does everything, tires, auto work, engines, and has a love and passion for diesels. Good luck, Cowboys. We are with you all the way. Sulphur Springs Valley Electric Cooperative, serving our community. The Ed Morse Automotive Group, formerly Lawely Automotive, is now serving Cochise County. Ed Morse Automotive Group of Sierra Vista. We are committed to making a long-lasting, positive relationship with the community. Stop in today and experience the difference. Cochise County is now backed by Morse. Bowie Pecans, America's only native tree nut. American is pecan pie and Friday night football. Good luck, Willcox. We back you all the way at Bowie Pecan Farm. Willcox Livestock Auction is Arizona's oldest livestock auction, serving all of Arizona and southwestern New Mexico. Good luck, Willcox football players. Marathon Truck Stop Willcox Express Store proudly supports and sponsors all of Willcox and their youth. Stop by and see Robin, Michelle, Maria, and Carlos. Mention you heard it in Cool FM and receive a free 22-ounce fountain drink or coffee. TMB Tire Service Willcox. We specialize in tire sales and tire repairs for passenger vehicles, semis, and farm equipment. Over 45 years of experience. Come down and see Mark Teeters at 2060 North Haskell Avenue for all your tire needs. And last but not least, Big Tex Barbecue. Always proud to support our young Cowboy athletes and all they do. We are so proud of you from Big Tex Barbecue in Willcox. And that's going to bring up second down for the Willcox Cowboys.
Yep. So they got stopped on that first down after about a carry of three. Second down and seven.
And so this is going to be important. Willcox plays power football. And so that's exactly what they're going to do. They're going to give it to number 12 down the sideline. He's going to try to find some daylight. And he's going to get swallowed up on the sideline. That's going to be number 12, Remington Todd, for the Cowboys on the carry. And he looked like he really didn't have anywhere to go on the sideline.
No. Yeah, he ran around that outside and didn't really have a spot to go. It looks like the safeties and the outside linebackers really are swarming to the running game right now, so they're kind of keeping an eye out. Thank you, Amanda. Yeah, let's go, Cowboys.
Yeah, it looks like these outside linebackers know that they have their work cut out for them tonight. So this is going to bring up third down, third and about seven. And they're going to try to run it to the right side. That's going to be number 24 himself. Yeah. The Warden down the middle. And that's going to be a first down for the Cowboys. And that's a great run down the middle.
Yeah, I mean, 16 yards up the middle. You got to be proud of that. And look how big these linemen are for Willcox.
Yeah, I mean, Willcox has some big guys.
Give number seven the ball. Let's go, Anthony. That's coming in from Reese Bakar.
So this is going to be first and 10 for the Cowboys. And they're going to line up in their power set, stacking the box with one out. And they're going to hand it down the middle. Number 13, Ismael Cuevas on the carry. And that's half of their dual-headed dragon at running back between Landon Ward and Ismael Cuevas. And it looks like they're going to get started early here. Wilcox's backfield tonight, I expect them to have a pretty big night. Landon Ward averaging 144 yards a game.
He's an incredible runner. I'm so happy to be seeing him here in the playoff game. And you know, they're running the ball after that first play. Wilcox is really showing that they can hold their own.
Yeah, and I mean, I've never seen him, Landon Ward, play, and I've heard about him. And he's really kind of living up to the hype just from what I've seen right now in his first carry.
For sure.
And they're going to give the ball to number 12, Remington Todd, going through the gap. And he found the gap quick. And there's going to be a flag on the play from the sideline.
Wow, he was looking for contact. He came around that edge. You see a big running back coming down and trying to put the punishment on a defensive back. I mean, you're a defensive back and you're a running back, so you know how that looks.
Yeah, and that looks like it's going to be a holding call on the Cowboys. And that's going to come back. So that'll bring up second down again. And that's going to move this ball back probably about 4 yards.
All right.
Well, jeez, that's a killer.
I know, after 16 yards.
Penalties like that, that can make or break the game, honestly.
Yeah, absolutely. Look at this defense. Big dudes all the way across. Look at their defensive line. You know, number 56.
When I was walking in, their safety passed me, and that's a big guy.
Yeah.
That's a big guy.
Yep.
So they're going to line up. Landon Ward's going to get the handoff, and he's just following his blockers, and that's going to be another first down for the Cowboys. And you can just see he's patient with the run. He's following his blockers, letting everything set up. But he's also explosive behind them, so he can break out of it quick.
Yeah, he's clearly very quick and patient. Two things you don't want to see that in a running back that you're playing against, for sure.
Yeah, and I mean, again, like I said, all I've heard is talk about him.
Yeah, he's an awesome player.
He got nominated for the Ed Doherty Award.
Yeah, you were telling me about that. What kind of an award is that?
So that's for the most prestigious athletes in Arizona. And clearly, I mean, he is one. And they're going to hand the ball off to 13 down the middle. And he's going to keep going for more yards. That's going to be Ismael Cuevas. And that's going to bring up first and 10 for the Cowboys again.
Gain of 12 on the play.
And he got the first down by a mile. It was first down. He got another first down.
Yeah, this running game is not being stopped so far. You got to wonder what the rest of the game has in store. I mean, look at the defense. A couple of these guys are yelling at each other, so you know that this isn't something that they see all the time.
Yeah, and I mean, playing a team whose quarterback has only thrown enough touchdowns I can count on one hand, you got to expect the run game's coming hard.
Exactly.
They're going to toss it to Landon Ward down the sideline. Jeez. He's going to get tripped up. But he's still going to gain about 4 yards. So that's going to bring up second down for the Cowboys. And, I mean, even games that don't look like they're going very far, he's pushing them.
Oh, yeah. 144 yards per game. You got to wonder if that's all big runs or if that's him chipping away 5 yards per carry, or is that, you know, smaller even than that?
Yeah, and I mean, this offense, they look like they're lining up in a different kind of set.
I love that.
And they're
going
to give the ball to him again. He's going to spin past the linebacker, and he's going to gain 7 yards, and that's going to bring up first down for the Cowboys.
Very cool misdirection play. So number 24 plays kind of like a slot running back, and you could see him. What he did was he takes a step back as the linemen pull in front of him, then the ball is handed to him, and then he just follows the linemen through. The world's biggest fullbacks are your linemen. Those are fun guys to run behind.
Definitely. And so this is going to be first and 10 for the Cowboys from the 23-yard line, and they're going to hand it to number 12 down the middle, Remington Todd. And so that's going to bring up second and 3 for the Cowboys, and they're just chipping away at this defense, really.
Yeah. I mean, their running game, like we saw, is just about the toughest we've seen. I mean, this is competitive with, I'd even say, bigger schools, let's say even 5A.
Yeah, and I mean, you can just see that they've been kind of running the ball all year. They look experienced behind the run game. So it's going to be second down, and they're going to run the misdirection to the warden himself, and he's going to make a man miss. And then it looks like he's going to get enough yards for a first down. And that's going to bring first and goal for the Cowboys, knocking on the door of their first score of the game on a drive led by their run game.
Yep. 5 minutes, 30 seconds left in the game. 0-0 score. They are knocking on the door.
And I mean, I think they could get it here in the next two plays, to be honest, the way they've been running the ball.
Yeah.
So they're going to give it to number 12, and he's going to punch it in for a touchdown for the Cowboys. That's going to be number 12, Remington Todd. And it looks like they might have a three-headed monster in the backfield.
True. He was looking for contact, too. Like, as soon as he crossed the line, he was just looking to put his head down and roll over someone.
Excuse me, that's going to be number 13 getting touchdown, Ismael Cuevas.
All right.
And now he's going to, well, looks like, kick the extra point, so he's their running back and their kicker, too.
Very cool. Score is now 6-0.
And that touchdown is going to be brought to you by Mills Tire and Tech. Family owned since 2010. Owner Brian Mills does everything, tires, auto work, engines, and has a love and passion for diesels. Good luck, Cowboys. We are with you all the way. And how about the Cowboys on that first drive? Yeah. Really just taking chunks out of this defense.
Oh, huge chunks, like 5 yards per carry. That was more than 5 yards per carry. That was a six. It was six plays, and they went 80 yards, you know?
Yeah,
that's pretty good.
They were taking chunks out of this defense, and it looked like they might have stalled out a little bit earlier in the drive, got to third down,
yep.
And then it was just back-to-back-to-back first downs.
Their line is so big. Honestly, like, the tackles on each side look like they're at least 6'2", maybe 6'3". I mean, when you got guys that big protecting you, and you got guys that can push up the middle, you got to be super happy about that.
Yeah, they're some big guys, and that's a line I'd love to follow behind if I was Landon Ward, and he's got some guys leading the way for him. And so Willcox is going to kick the ball off
big
here.
Big kick.
And that's a deep kick.
Yeah.
He's going to field it inside the five.
He's crazy.
And then he's going to be swallowed down.
Oh, the ball's on the
and
ground.
It looks like he fumbled the ball, and Willcox is going to get the ball, it looks like. Willcox ball inside the 15-yard line.
Whoa.
And the Cowboys are showing some hope.
I didn't realize it. This is the away team right over here. I was looking at the stands. Half the stands here are full of Willcox fans.
Yeah, it's split right down the middle. We've got Scottsdale Prep on the right and Willcox on the left.
Wow.
And it looks like Willcox came out to support their Cowboys tonight.
For sure. This is a traveling squad. If you got this many people coming from Willcox, good Lord, that's a long drive.
It's that small town community support. And this is going to be first down for the Cowboys, stacking the box. And they're going to hand it off down the middle. And that's going to be a touchdown for the Cowboys. That's going to be number 13, Cuevas, again.
Oh,
that's
man.
His second touchdown of the game.
Yeah, that's they're not stopping the run. So those guards are getting so much push. So I've been watching the guards. The guard, they keep running to the same side, the same trap motion, and they're running the running back right in the same groove every single time. He either bounces it inside or outside. You know, if you got one play that you keep running that doesn't, it can't be stopped, might as well keep going with it.
Yeah, and it looks like that's what they're really going to do, is try to keep running that all night until they start stacking the box, and then they're going to start taking it outside.
Yep, exactly, exactly.
And so now they're just gashing away at this defense.
14-0 in the first quarter. I did not see that coming.
Yeah,
I did not see that at all.
I really thought that I would get to see Scottsdale Prep's offense take the field. I was kind of excited to see what they were working with.
Yeah.
And then Willcox scored another touchdown.
Yeah, man, I'm telling you, Willcox is putting the points up. And we've seen them put up points. But we've seen Scottsdale Prep put up 81 points. Both these teams can score a ton. So what we're doing is we're just seeing who can, which one of these Titans will last, you know?
Yeah, and I mean, right now, Willcox's offense is obviously just kind of gashing away.
Yeah.
But I want to see what kind of offense Scottsdale Prep runs, whether they're a pass-heavy offense or run-heavy offense, or if they're really just kind of spread down the middle.
And I kind of want to see what this Willcox defense has available, mm-hmm. because that could be really interesting. Let's say Willcox's defense isn't any good. Then the score just goes 14-7 to like 21-14. You know, it could be just a huge game tonight.
And so Willcox is going to kick the ball off again. And he's going to try to bring that down the middle. And he's going to go down right around the 28-yard line. And so now Scottsdale Prep's offense is going to take over on downs. And this is going to be my first time seeing them tonight. And this first down is going to be brought to you by Sulphur Springs Valley Electric Cooperative, serving our community. And I'm excited to see what they have going on. And it looks like Wilcox's linebackers, they're running a three front.
Yeah, three linemen. Four linebackers, it looks like, but I'm not totally sure.
So this is kind of, and he's going to run it to the right side, and he's going to get about 4 yards. So that's going to bring up second and six.
Yeah, I mean, that was a good run.
And that's kind of the cover three look I was telling you about earlier.
Yeah.
With three down, three linebackers. And then they have the two extra on the outside, the Bandits.
Oh, yeah. So you see a bunch of
seeing.
Yeah, that's a good point. So Logan was pointing out that it looks like they've either got two extra. Oh, look at all four wide receivers going out.
Four out wide.
Where are we looking?
This could be a screen play.
Yep. Or like a bubble screen.
That's exactly what it is.
Yeah, it is.
So he's going to catch it, and he's going to go. And he's going.
Oh, wow.
That guy is quick.
He's gone.
He is quick down the sidelines.
Oh, my God.
Touchdown for number 44 from Scottsdale Prep Academy. 14, excuse me.
Touchdown, Scottsdale. Wow.
Yeah, that was a quick play.
Yeah, one play. No, two plays. But we did see that. We saw that. We were looking at that bubble pass, and that's exactly what it was.
That's going to be the safety I was telling you about, the big safety, number 14, Will Ryken, and he looks like he could be one of those splash players in tonight's game, one of those players that really makes the difference.
Yeah.
And he caught that and really ran it in effortlessly.
Yeah, he did a great job.
So that's going to make the score 6-14. And that kicker just sent the ball into the parking lot.
Oh, my.
And it looked like it almost hit a car.
No, I'm pretty sure it did. Yeah. Yeah. That.
So the Cowboys are going to be on top 14-7 early in this game. And it looks like right now Boyne is on top of Cienega 7-0.
Oh, man.
And Bisbee's on top of Campo Verde 14-0.
Oh, my gosh. Cochise County just representing big time.
Yeah, so, I mean, really, we could go. We're 1-0 in the playoffs. 1-1 in the playoffs right now, excuse me.
Yep.
After this game, we have a chance to go to 2-1, and then Bisbee 3-1.
Yeah. I mean,
Cochise County teams are really putting it on for the city.
Yeah, it's incredible.
And so Scottsdale Prep is going to kick the ball off here again. And that's going to be a deep kick. Fielded inside the 10. That's going to be the warden himself fielding it. And he's going to have nowhere to really go. He's going to get swallowed up by a swarm of defenders right around the 25-yard line. And now the Willcox offense is going to take over behind their hoss of some linemen.
For sure.
And I guarantee you they're going to try to continue attacking the run game here. And just abuse this defense and abuse these linebackers and force this safety to kind of step up into the box. You can see he's playing like 20 yards back right now.
Yeah, what's he looking for? So is he defending the run or the pass?
It looks like he's trying to defend these slots. Okay. It looks like he might be manned up on these slots a little bit.
Okay.
So they're going to motion. He's going to run it to the near side. That's going to be number 12.
Jeez, not going down.
And he was not going down without a fight. That's going to be Remington Todd on the carry. And there is a flag on the play. And it took three or four defenders to even get him out of bounds.
Yeah, that's a tough kid, man. Is he a senior?
He is a senior.
Not surprised. He is a big, strong kid, man. That's not a freshman.
So that's going to be a holding call on the Cowboys. And so that run is going to come back from the spot.
Yeah,
that's going to redo first down.
Bummer.
So that's going to move this ball back 10 yards.
It will be first and 20 for the Cowboys.
Oh, my gosh.
Jeez.
But, you know, they put together a huge, that last drive, or that first drive was an 80-yard drive. So.
Yeah, I mean, Willcox is no stranger to playing behind the sticks,
yep,
and playing tough football. And really, they can still score this drive.
Oh,
a penalty is not going to set them back.
No, not at all.
So they're going to line up with two out wide. And they're going to hand it off to Landon Ward.
Jeez.
And he's going to break it back down the middle, and he's not going down.
Same play.
And, I mean, he's really taking chunks out of the middle, 10 yards down the middle.
Yep, every time. Man. Can you imagine having a beast of a running back like that that's just picking up five every single time at minimum, you know?
Yeah, and I mean, he's making these linebackers miss in the
yep.
second level, so he's forcing the safety to come up.
It's almost like he's making them miss just before he gets to the hole, or just as he's getting to the hole, he's shaking them. All right.
So this is going to be 2nd and 10 for the Cowboys. And they're going to hand it off to Ismael Cuevas, and he's going to get about 3 yards. And so it's going to be third down for the Cowboys. And they're going to have to get the first down here or punt the ball. I mean, they're in their own territory.
Third down. Yeah, third and, you know, they can get seven on this.
Oh, yeah.
And if it's a short yardage and they're picking up 5 yards per carry, then they might as well go for it on fourth down, too.
Right. And, I mean, they have the running backs to do it.
Oh, yeah.
I just want to see kind of what these receivers are about, if they're going to try to pass the ball at all this game. So it's going to be third down.
He's
and it
throwing.
Looks like he's going to try to pass it right here. And it looks like they're trying to signal interception, and it's intercepted.
Wow.
Diving on the ground. Scottsdale Prep intercepted that pass, diving on the ground through the receiver.
Incredible catch. I couldn't tell where that ball landed, and he stands up with the ball, and there it is. Nice pick.
I just saw the sideline get energetic, knowing that he picked it, and then the refs were a little late calling it, so I was left in suspense.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's going to be first down for Scottsdale Prep. And they're going to line up everybody out wide. They're going to motion number 14 and hit him on another screen.
Oh, my gosh. Look
at
that.
And he made a miss, and then he made another one.
He's not going down, though.
He's tall.
Oh,
he's
yeah.
He's tall and he's strong. He's hard to take down in the open field is what it looks like.
Yeah.
He's 6'2". He's 6'2" playing slot receiver.
Yeah, that's a bit. So I like big slot receivers, but I like them. So like Juju Smith-Schuster, I like these big slots because you can slide them in and they can block. So it's like having an extra tight end, and then you slide him out. That's why I like Brock Bauer so much. Might as well be a wide receiver or a fullback because of the way he blocks and the way he catches.
Right. And so now they're spreading out the field once again.
Oh, yeah. Nobody in the backfield.
And so they're going to motion him across again. And now they're looking to take a money shot here.
Oh, wow.
And I thought he was going to come. I thought he was going to come down with that.
Oh, man.
I thought he was going to come down with that.
Young man had that ball right there. And the Willcox defender came down in front of it. Like, I thought both of them had the chance at the ball, and then the receiver just kind of, I don't know if he let up or what happened there, but he just didn't go after the ball.
I mean, it looked like the Willcox defender had a hand in there.
Yeah.
And that's really what led to the deflection. And you can't see it from up here, but this Scottsdale Prep quarterback is a big guy.
Yeah, he's not small at all.
He's 6'2", 205 pounds.
What?
Playing quarterback. And so they're gonna run it with him down the middle.
Oof.
And he's no stranger to contact, it looks like, trying to take the head-on hit from two linebackers.
Yeah.
And that looks like it's going to be a first down, and it will be. And so that's going to be a first down for Scottsdale Prep.
Scottsdale coming alive. You know, what can you do?
Yeah, I mean, this offense looks electric.
Yeah.
This offense looks like kind of like they've been clicking all year.
Yeah, you got to wonder how much of, I mean, scoring two touchdowns in the very beginning, you're expecting, like, possibly a blowout, but definitely not now.
So they're going to throw the screen pass again.
And oh!
That was almost intercepted.
Hit him
by
in
Landon
the hands.
Ward.
Yeah.
A diving interception, and it went incomplete in and out of his hands.
Yeah, that was great. I mean, not only was that great defense, but like he was seeing where that ball was going. The quarterback threw the ball to the right spot. The wide receiver wasn't in the right spot. The defensive back moved in and supplanted him.
Yeah, so I mean, he knew where the ball was going. Mm-hmm. It looked like he'd really been watching that play on film, studying it all week.
Yep, film study.
And was ready for it. And he's been waiting on that play all game. So now this is going to bring up 2nd and 10 for Scottsdale Prep. And they're going to drop back to pass. And they're going to find number one in the flat. And that's going to bring up 3rd and 6.
Man.
3rd and 6 for Scottsdale Prep.
Yep.
and it looks like they're going to move this ball inside the 25-yard line. So they're knocking on the door of the red zone. But it is third down.
Yeah, it is third down. We get to see what that 3-3-5 defense can do. Three down linemen, three linebackers, and five defensive backs.
And so it looks like that's going to be the end of the first quarter.
Oh, man. Are we going to be able to handle this cold? I don't know, man. I didn't bring any shoe warmers.
It is a little cold. It's a little warmer than it is in Cochise County
right
now.
Oh, thank God.
So it's a little nice little break, but it's still a little chilly.
Yeah, if you were out at the game that Logan was playing at last night, two of my fingers fell off in the game because it was so cold. The wind was just taking it out of us. There was no heat left in my body.
Yeah.
How did you survive?
I had a hand warmer. I had one finger going numb the entire game.
Oh,
I had a hand warmer specifically for one of my fingers to keep it from going numb.
Oh, man. This is Logan Seeley, the stud quarterback, defensive back from Breen High School. He's an incredible player. The best part is, let me see, he knows football. We talked football up and down when we were coming up the freeway to this game. And this young man, 18 years old, knows football well beyond his years. It's a lot of fun to talk to him. As you can see, he knows what he's talking about.
Thank you.
Dude, it's always good to work with someone that knows. Jeff is great, you're great, Jared's great. You don't want me by myself, is what I'm trying to say. Add me to anything.
So now this is gonna be third down for Scottsdale Prep, and they're gonna have two in the backfield, and they're gonna run a play action and
nice.
Throw it to the flat number three, and he's gonna break a tackle, and he was gonna try to score, but he went out of bounds. You can see the explosiveness just in his movements that he was about to try to dive for that pylon.
Oh yeah. Yeah, he just came up just a little bit short, stepped out of bounds. They are the passing team in between the two. So what are we going to see? Are we going to see a run? They do the play action. Maybe it's a play action pass. What are you thinking?
They're probably, I mean, their quarterback's a big guy. They're probably going to run it with him right here.
Oh, yeah.
I can just see it coming.
Yep.
And that's exactly what they're going to do.
Yep.
And he's going to, is he going to score? He's going to be short.
Yeah, about a yard and a half.
One-yard line. And I mean, now you have a big quarterback, 205 pounds, 6'2". You can just run it down the middle with him and force them to try to stop him.
Yep.
And this offense really is kind of what I was expecting. This is a strong offense here. And so they're going to line up, nobody next to the quarterback. They're all going to be down. And that's exactly what they're going to do, is force their hand. And they're going to stop him.
They stopped him again.
On the goal line.
Oh, my gosh. Ben, that don't break.
Third down. And so it looks like this Willcox defense isn't going to let them score without putting up a fight here.
For sure.
So this could be time for a little play action.
Looks like they're calling a timeout here. One of the teams is calling timeout. Oh, it might be a referee timeout. It looks like they're discussing where the ball was.
So they're going to mark this ball at the half-yard line.
Oh, dude, that is...
Willcox has a half a yard to try to defend them from scoring a touchdown and possibly tying this game up right now.
Man, I'm sending someone up the middle if I'm on defense.
And so Scottsdale Prep is going to score on their third try with their quarterback. And that's going to make the score 13-14. And they could tie it up here if they make the extra point.
Man, Willcox looked so good in the very beginning. But that defense, like Scottsdale Prep has another good offense. So it's Willcox's offense is awesome. Scottsdale Prep's offense is awesome. It's neither defense is, well, I actually think Willcox's defense is pretty impressive so far, but we got to see what Scottsdale can do coming forward.
We've already seen four touchdowns scored.
Yeah, already
in a quarter and a minute into this game.
Yep.
I mean, these are two high-powered offenses from what I'm seeing.
Oh, yeah. This doesn't look like two-way ball either. You see how many kids are on the sideline? You've got 38 on the far sideline. I think I counted 50.
I believe there were 47 on roster when I was looking at it earlier for Scottsdale Prep.
Wow, that's
so this is a big roster.
Yeah, for 2A.
Oh,
he got it!
He blocked it! Landon Ward blocked the extra point.
Gosh, does he just do everything?
He blocked the extra point. He almost had an interception.
And now run for a touchdown. He had that 30-yard run. He had the 16-yarder.
Now that I'm thinking about it, if he would have gotten that interception, they wouldn't have scored on that drive.
Yeah, right.
So, I mean, now Willcox is still on top, 14-13 in the second quarter. And so, I mean, really right now we get to see Wilcox's offense come back onto the field. And I'm kind of expecting them to not try to pass it again this drive. They threw an interception last drive on the sideline.
Yeah, you're going to just have to watch them run the ball all game long.
And, I mean, I think they could do that from what I'm seeing out of their run game so far.
For sure. We would like to welcome everybody from Scottsdale friends and family. We would like to welcome all the people from Willcox or Cochise County checking in. If you're checking in from outside of any of those areas, say hi. Tell us where you're at. We would love to hear from you. Scottsdale Prep with a kick. They got a big leg, too.
They do have a really good kicker.
Jeez.
And that ball went. That's going to be fielded at the 9 by Landon Ward, and he's going to try to take it. And he looks like he's tough to bring down.
Yeah. I'm not expecting him to run the 40 and 4-3 or anything like that, but he's kind of a truck.
I mean, he looks quick, and it looks like Scottsdale Prep is going to have an injured player going down, and it looks like he's holding his knee.
The ball will be spotted at the 28-yard line.
You got to hope he's going to get up soon. I hate seeing injuries.
Those are killers. And you can hear him.
Yeah. We talk about good and bad about injuries, and there are things where, like, you get an injury. Well, you know what? They got his leg bent over there. That's not typically like a, I don't know. I had a torn ACL, and I'll say, like, what you do is you pull on it to see if there's any kind of, like, extra room in there. Doesn't look like they're pulling on it yet, but it could be anything. But cold night here in Scottsdale.
Oh yeah.
My goodness, it's nice and clear. At least it's clear. But man, when it's clear, it gets cold. So we're up here on the metal floor, so we get to absorb all the cold from.
Luckily, there's no breeze.
No breeze.
It doesn't feel like any breeze right
now.
Yeah,
not like last night. Holy smokes, that was about the coldest it could get. Yeah. I don't know if you think Warden can run a 4-3. You haven't seen much yet. So if he can run a 4-3, you got to tell me, because that kid's going to...
That's pro D1. Numbers. Yeah, that's pro numbers.
That's easy D1. So if he's running a 4-3, we got to start... We got to get some more scouting out there. I hadn't heard that he could run a 4-3. But Hey, if he can do it... It's cold out, so you don't actually run your fastest when it's cold either. Like, I can run long distances when it's cold, but sprinting is not it.
I mean, we've got to get U of A out here. It looks like they could use him this year.
Oh, for sure.
And maybe next year. And so the injured player is going to get up.
Oh, man. Yeah, he's got something going on with that right leg. Not putting any weight on it at all. And he's trying to keep it straight. Oh, okay. So, yeah, he can't move his leg at all.
Yeah.
He's trying to keep his foot from touching the ground, because you can tell that's a knee injury right there. Oh, that's such a bummer. Hopefully.
Yeah, that's a tough,
hopefully
tough break.
He recovers quickly. But I'll say this, knee injuries are not what they used to be. We were talking about, I've had an ACL. I recovered fully. Oh, my gosh. Get up there and dunk a ball still. Yeah, you can recover.
So hopefully he'll be all good. He's going to go to the training table. And this Willcox offensive drive is going to be brought to you by the Ed Morse Automotive Group, now serving our community in Cochise County. And this is going to be first down, a toss to Landon Ward on the outside. And he's making a cut. And he's going to get 7 yards. And that's going to bring up second and three.
Yep. Score is 14-13, Willcox with the lead with 10 minutes left.
And watching this Willcox offense click is just like nothing other than spectacular.
Yeah, it's so fun. When you see someone that's really good at what they do, like, it's hard not to watch.
And so it's going to be second down, and they're going to hand it down the middle. And that's going to be, they're going to spot this ball at a first down, and that's going to bring up a first down from Landon Ward.
Yeah.
And so now the Willcox Cowboys are getting this run game going again.
Yep. You wonder if they're going to try and run the clock out. So in your game last night, you guys ran out the entire clock in the first quarter without the other team even touching the ball. Is that a possibility? Do you think that that could happen?
I mean, running the ball, I think you always kind of can think that's going to happen. And so I really do think that could happen if they don't score too quick.
He is not. That was first contact and second contact, and he went another 5 yards.
Yeah, so it looked like those two linebackers tried to hit him. Yep. And then there's nobody in the second level to stop him from getting another 10 yards, and the safety had to come up.
Yeah, he's a big running back. You can't tackle with your arms. You can't tackle with your hands. You can't tackle with a corner.
And you definitely can't tackle with your hands right now.
Oh, not when it's cold.
I can only imagine they can barely feel him right now. And so it's going to be first and 10 for the Cowboys. And they're going to stack the box again. Ooh. And that's going to be a flag. And it looks like it could be a false start.
Yeah. Oh, it was on the defense. So, yeah,
encroachment.
He was either across the line, lined up across the line, or he jumped. And I didn't really see a jump. So I'm just guessing that his head was hanging out there.
It looked like he could have been lined up across the line. And so now Willcox is going to get an extra 5 yards, a free 5 yards.
Yep.
And it's going to bring up first and five.
Yeah, well, you know that they can get first and five for sure. We got to see. Yeah, well, those cheerleaders are pretty fantastic. They're down on the sideline, too. Thank you for checking in, Ms. Avila.
And so they're going to try to run the ball.
There they go, right up the middle.
And that's going to be, there's going to be a horse collar tackle right there.
What?
Maybe a face mask. Oh, but I saw his neck go backwards.
Oh, no. I hate face masking. We play with helmets all the time. I've had my head pulled nearly off a couple times. I'll tell you, not a good feeling. But that's why you work your neck out. We would always do bridges like wrestlers. So you hold on to your helmet, your face mask with your hands, and then you put your head on the back and you just make a back bridge, but you just hold all your body weight with your head.
Yeah, working on strengthening those muscles, those stabilizers in your neck.
Thank you, Robin Moreau, for updating the score. We really appreciate that.
And so this is going to be first and 10 from the 26-yard line for Willcox. And they're going to run this ball to Landon Ward once again. And he's going to get 7 yards. He's going to get 7 yards.
He runs up the middle for 7. He runs onto the outside for 7. What are you doing?
And averaging 144 yards a game.
Yeah, I mean, probably 7 yards per carry, too.
I feel like I can't drill that home enough just how insane that is.
It's insane. Two-way football, there should not be a player that goes for 144 yards per game.
And so they're going to line up, still stacking the box. And they're going to hand the ball off to Quavis down the middle.
Oh,
and he's
going to
fumble. And who's got it?
Wow.
Scottsdale Prep has the ball.
Oh, turn
over. And that drive looked like it was going somewhere. Willcox could have scored. And then they fumble the ball.
Well, it's cold out. You know, we were talking about like how your hands don't work so well when it's cold. Man, that just goes to show. Fumbles come easy when it's cold.
Yeah, whenever it's cold, it feels like even if you have gloves on, your gloves lose grip, your fingers
it's
lose
true.
Grip.
They absolutely
You're losing
do.
Everything. So you're more likely to see a fumble. And so that's why I'm a little surprised almost to see Scottsdale Prep trying to pass the ball here. Your receivers can't feel their hands.
Yeah, you want to run the ball if you can.
So it's going to be first down for Scottsdale Prep for the Spartans.
Oh, weird handoff.
That's a fumbled snap.
Okay, it looked like they were snapping to the offset running back. Like a wildcat.
It looked like the quarterback and the running back were both trying to take the snap.
Yeah.
I couldn't tell which center might have gotten a little confused.
Oh. And as a deep snapper, you know what you're looking at. It can happen. You know you're looking between your legs. Throwing that ball backwards, yeah, absolutely, it can get a little confusing back there.
Yeah, and I mean, they were both lined up ready for the snap. And so I don't know if he was trying to snap it to the running back or the quarterback.
Oh, they're doing the four receivers to one side.
Here we go. Here's the screen.
Drop the ball
and
again!
He's going to fumble it.
Did they get it in the end zone? There is another fumble on the exchange. Oh, my. Willcox playing huge ball. Recovered by the
Spartans. Scottsdale Prep has the ball in the half-yard line.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, you're looking at a safety now.
It really looked like Willcox recovered the ball, and I thought they scored it.
I thought so, too.
I thought they recovered it for a touchdown. And the refs have for the screen.
Thankfully, the refs have a better view on it than I do because my eyes are not what they used to be. And I'll tell you, I was sure that was a touchdown.
If I was up here, I probably would have called that Willcox ball if I was
right.
And they did try to run the screen. You saw the quarterback flip his hips, the receiver come back for
yep.
the ball.
Yep, that was going to be a screen.
And he just couldn't catch the snap.
Oh, they're spreading everybody out to this side.
So they're going to drop back to pass. And that's going to be caught. And then dropped by the receiver.
Dude,
it looked like the contact broke it up.
It's cold. That guy is not going to handle that ball very well. It hit him in the hip. Like, that ball was coming in, and it just was too much velocity. Just right through his hands, off his body.
Yeah, and I mean, it's cold, cold weather out here.
Yeah, not good.
We have an illegal shift on the Spartans.
Oh, I would decline that too.
I thought it would be a false start. I saw movement.
Oh wow.
And it looked weird. It looked like really weird non-football movement. But I didn't know if they were gonna call a false start for it, and it looked like it was an illegal shift.
Yeah.
So now their punter is gonna have his heels on the back of the end zone trying to punt the ball here.
Not a good feeling. If you have punted out of an end zone, it's like the scariest thing actually, because you lose about 3 yards of area to kick from. Are they gonna try and block this? Oh, they got two kick returners. Yeah, this is
that's a pretty solid punt. And so that's going to be, he's going to go down at about the 31 yard line. So Willcox is going to take over with tremendous field position here.
And thank you for checking in. We're already up to 92 people watching from Willcox. Thank you so much for checking in. Robin, thank you so much for updating the score for us. We try and keep you up to date, but, you know, having it written down. We're very blessed to have a dude that's willing to do that for us, so thank you. Ooh, updates from all the other games, too. You guys are awesome. Bisbee up 19-7.
So Bisbee is playing Bisbee football.
Yeah.
I mean, they're going into the postseason 9-1.
I think the championship comes out of Cochise County.
Oh, I definitely believe so. And Landon Ward getting to the outside, getting 9.5 yards. And so that's going to bring up 2nd and inches. And this second down is going to be brought to you by Bowie Pecans, America's only native tree nut.
Cool.
American is pecan pie in Friday Night Football. Good luck, Willcox. We back you all the way at Bowie Pecan Farm. And I didn't know the pecan is the only American tree nut.
Yeah, dude, pecans are amazing.
I learn something new every day.
Yeah, you can survive on pecans.
And so it's going to be 2nd and 1. And they're going to run it down the middle to number 12. And he's going to not get back to the line. And they're going to lose a yard on offense.
Yep. But that was a cool play. That was a nice little counter play. So they're expecting it to go to number 24, Landon. And they handed it to the other wing back that was coming back. And they created like a double trap. So it looked like a trap going one direction. And then they brought like another counter lineman in to hit that defensive end.
And
unfortunately,
it
didn't work.
It looked like those linebackers really stayed disciplined.
Oh, yeah.
And were doing a great job tracking the ball to stop that play. And so now they're going to run it down the middle of Clavis.
You can't stop the run.
You can't, especially when these running backs are as strong and as quick as they are. You're going to have a hard time trying to stop them. And this is going to be first down. Inside the red zone now.
Yep.
And Willcox needs to play mistake-free football here if they want to score.
They've got 4 minutes left in the half. And to score right here would be absolutely amazing, because scoring before the end of the half, that's always my thing. I mean, even if you got to do a two-minute drill to score before the end of the half, because what comes out of the half is what you just put into it.
You're going to get a lot of momentum if you score right before halftime.
Huge momentum shift, yep.
And so they're going to hand this ball to Ward down the middle. And he is quick.
Oh, he's still going.
He's quick.
Yeah.
He just covered 15 yards in about a half a second.
Yeah. So maybe that 4-3 is actually the right number.
And it looked like he was jogging.
Yeah. So that's the funny thing about tall dudes and long striders. You can't tell that they're very, that they have a lot of acceleration, because you're tall, it looks like you're moving in slow motion. But you get those legs moving like Usain Bolt is 6'4", right? Like,
yeah.
There are fast dudes that are tall.
So now they're lining Landon Ward out at receiver now. And they're going to run it down the middle.
Jeez. That line must be just unstoppable.
So that's going to be Remington Todd getting about a yard. It's second and goal for Willcox.
2 minutes 40 left in the quarter, in the half.
Willcox is knocking on the door of scoring their third touchdown.
Score is 14-13. Willcox with the lead.
And really, these defenses have played really good this entire second quarter. Yeah. They played great football.
Yeah. It's just both offensive lines are better than the defensive lines.
And so this is second down.
And
he fumbled the ball.
No!
And Scottsdale Prep picked it up. And it looks like he's going to go coast to coast. Oh, my gosh. There's going to be a block in the back.
Oh, no, that's going to bring it back. That's going to null the touchdown. They're going to take that touchdown off the back. Oh, no, that's got to be brutal.
I thought there was going to be a fight. I'm not going to lie.
No, that's a block in the back.
It looked like Quavis
Unreal.
Was just headhunting.
He was way, way out in the front. Like, you don't do that. Oh, no.
Is that coming back?
I don't know. Are they saying that he scored first? Okay, so they're saying he scored before there was a block in the back. It looked like he got it before that touchdown, honestly. So the touchdown counts. The score is now 19-14.
So now, and I mean, I really thought there was going to be a fight. Things were looking chippy.
Yeah.
He was just hunting players down.
Yep.
He was pushed down.
Someone's got to talk to him about that. Like, he could have taken a touchdown off the board if that had gone the other direction.
And so they're going to line up, I believe, to kick the extra point here.
They're calling a timeout.
And this timeout is going to be brought to you by the Willcox Livestock Auction. Arizona's oldest livestock auction, serving all of Arizona and southwestern New Mexico. And they say, good luck, Willcox football players.
Yep.
All the way from Willcox.
A lot of good luck, a lot of warm wishes to the Willcox team. Amanda Avila, thank you.
And I mean, Willcox's offense, they've been marching down this field, getting all the way down the field, and then just having drive-killing fumbles.
Yeah, dude, that's the second one.
On back-to-back drives, they were inside the 20-yard line and then coughed the ball up.
Oh, man. That's heartbreaking. I mean, to have the ball at your own end zone, you're going to put the ball in. It's so cold, the ball comes out. You go 90 yards the opposite direction, 90-plus yards. Oh, man.
Yeah, that's definitely a killer, and that could kill some momentum.
Yeah,
your offense has. So it looks like they're gonna go for two here, and try to make this 21-14 here.
Yeah.
and so they're going to line up spread out with one in the backfield next to the quarterback.
Thank you, Robin.
And they're going to motion number 14 across. Here comes the rollout. And he was covered. Ooh. He was smothered.
And he throws!
And he throws it, and it's complete, but there will be a flag.
Oh.
There will be a flag, and they're, I believe that's going to be a holding call.
Yep. Yeah, he rolled out there pretty quick, and I think it was that tackle.
And that's just a killer. So it is a holding call, so that's going to move this ball back.
Yeah, do you think they kick now?
I think they're going to try to go for two again. This quarterback is getting the play call back.
Oh, man.
Oh, man. That's a great play by the quarterback still.
Yeah. Yeah, no.
To throw it out of being wrapped up. Yep. And throw it for a touchdown.
Yep. He threw that ball, and it was a laser. He hit that guy in that back corner where nobody else could get to it. Man, he reminds me of the Benson quarterback from last year. Benson had a gigantic quarterback last year. And that kid, I think he was predicted to go to a big school. He was like 6'5". But this guy, man, he's a big kid too. Holy smokes.
This guy's an athlete, and you can just see it. And so they're going to line up to pass it again. And he's scrambling.
Oh, he's got room. He's got room.
And he's going to find him open in the back corner.
He got it.
And they're going to call it in.
Oh, my.
And that's going to make the score 21-14. And they're saying there will be a quick answer from Landon Ward coming up. And I would love to see it.
Yeah, right.
A shootout to end the second quarter.
Yep. What a good game. It was, so they've scored 21 straight points now.
So Willcox was up 14-0 to start the second quarter. Mm-hmm. And Scottsdale Prep has scored 21 points in this second quarter so far.
Thank you, Michelle.
And so now we get to see Scottsdale Prep's kicker lineup.
Oh, there's another penalty. What's this about?
They're enforcing one of the possible penalties from the touchdown onto this kickoff.
Wow.
And this reminds me of the Bisbee Tombstone game where I saw the Bisbee kicker kick from the 30-yard line. It was the craziest thing I think I've ever seen.
I would do an onside kick if you got the ball on the other side of the 50 and it's got to go 10 yards. That means it's got to go to the 35. I would just do an onside kick and just
try
for it.
Exactly. I mean, you're going to get good field position to start for your defense anyway.
Oh, yeah.
And that looks like the perfect kick for this situation. And Landon Ward.
Wow.
Navigating through traffic.
Really?
And he's still going to keep going.
Dude, he has some really good balance. So you can see him running with all of his weight hanging off on one side or on the other. And he's still running forward as if he's got his balance under him. So one of my favorite running back of all time is Barry, of course. But right behind him is Marshawn Lynch. Both of those guys had the best balance I've ever seen. Marshawn Lynch was another 20 pounds heavier than Barry, of course. But you could pull full strength on either shoulder. He could carry you from one shoulder. That's how strong his balance
is. And that's kind of what all of Wilcox's running backs look like right
no
now.
No kidding. Yeah.
And so it's going to be 1st and 10 for the Cowboys. And they're going to run it down the middle to Landon Ward. And he's going to break a tackle. And he's going to keep going to the safety. And that's a gain of about 20.
Yeah.
And Landon Ward down the middle for 20 yards.
You got to hope that he can put it in the end zone. There's only a minute 30 left in the half.
I really thought he was going to break that loose and then just take off.
I know. He just wasn't going down.
And I want to see if he got into the open field. We saw how quick this safety was on his touchdown reception. If he could just burn the safety. And that's going to number 12. And he's looking for contact.
Yep. Yep.
He was looking for contact. Remington Todd.
Timeout Willcox. And stopping the clock at 1-1-1, 1-11.
These running backs are just strong.
Oh, yeah.
They're putting up a fight.
It looks like the coach makes them jog with 20-pound weights on each shoulder.
And so this timeout is going to be brought to you by the Marathon Truck Stop in Willcox, proudly supporting our proudly supporting and sponsoring all of Willcox and their youth. Stop by and see Robin, Michelle, Marie, and Carlos. Mention you heard it in Cool FM and receive a free 22-ounce fountain drink or coffee. And I'm going to have to go down there. I love fountain drinks.
Yeah, right? Robin, you're a good dude. We appreciate it.
And so now Willcox, they have to score to have a chance to tie this game up. Going into halftime, they're down 21-14 with a minute and 11 seconds left in the first half right here.
You know, the thing that I'm also noticing is it looks like they've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 seniors on this Scottsdale team.
So a quarter of their roster is seniors.
Yeah, pretty good. You got to be happy with something like that if you're that Scottsdale team.
And so they're going to pass the ball to Landon Ward.
Gosh.
And it looked like he just wasn't ready for the ball. He wasn't looking for the ball.
Well, Robin, we love you anyway. Even if female, male, either way, we love you. We appreciate the help.
And so this is 3rd and 5 for Willcox.
It's a 55-gallon metal trash can we carry around. Onward, Cowboys. I love it.
And that really just shows why the running backs are so strong.
Yeah, exactly.
So they're dropping back to pass, a slip screen to Landon Ward. And he was just swallowed up. They sniffed out the play call. But it looked like that play just took way too long to try to develop. And so this is going to be 4th and 10 for the Cowboys with 45 seconds left in the half.
All right, 39 seconds counting down. And it looks like there's another timeout.
It looks like with the refs are taking a referee timeout.
I bet that they're going to put some time back on the clock. Oh, they're telling people in the background to turn their headlights off. I'm not sure where the headlights are coming from, but they were saying that someone out beyond the field has headlights that are pointing at the game. So, I guess that's not a good thing.
I couldn't see headlights.
Dude, I couldn't see anything.
And so Willcox is going to punt the ball away.
Yeah, and look how many returners they have. I've never seen a 3-returner set before.
Oh! They faked the punt. They faked the punt.
Oh! But they came
and
up
they
short.
Fumbled it.
And they fumbled it? Oh, shoot. 7 seconds left. They were...
Oh, my gosh.
Yep.
That was a great acting job by the punter, I will say.
Yeah. Had me lost there for a second.
That was a great acting job by the punter. Throwing his body back like he...
I love it.
Yeah, I don't know what he was acting
snap.
Like.
No. I've seen that. Yeah, you act like it's a high snap and you turn around and everybody starts going after whatever the punter's looking at. You snap it to the up back. Actually, one of the funny things that they used to do is they would snap to a guy and they would put the ball on the ground and hand it back to the center. And the center wouldn't move. They called that a peanut play. I'm not sure why they called it a peanut play, but interesting nonetheless.
And so they're going to line up, maybe knee out this clock here.
Yeah. Oh.
And Willcox is going to get a false start.
Everybody jumped
off sides.
Flag on the play.
But it looks like they're going to call false start on the offense.
That's, I'm not sure.
I don't know if that was the right call.
Hey. It's one way or the other, they'll figure it out. But, like, I don't like complaining about bad calls, honestly. So maybe saw something
either sideline would be upset if the call went the other way.
I would be pissed if I was Scottsdale, honestly. But.
And so this is 1st and 15.
And they're running out the clock. Put your knee on the ground, my man. What's he doing? I guess he kneeled
it out. And he tossed the ball to ref.
Hey.
And so Scottsdale Prep is on top of Willcox 21-14.
Oh my gosh.
And this has been a great game for a playoff game.
Oh my gosh. You're not kidding, man. I mean, this game started off so hot with Willcox running the ball. They have taken the ball within the 10-yard line and fumbled twice. Oh, heartbreaking, heartbreaking. I mean, you have to be thinking what you could do to win, and it would be not fumbling the ball.
Yeah, and I mean, I think it really just comes down to discipline, carrying the ball right now, not letting the cold really affect you.
Yeah.
And I think that's kind of what's happening. But I do know Willcox has a great coaching staff. They have great leadership within their own team with the players. And so they're going to come out and give their team a crazy talk.
Yep.
Again, ladies and gentlemen,
a Benson coach level talk. And I know those talks are some of the best talks I've heard.
Yeah.
And they're going to come out in the second half fired up.
For sure. And it's been actually a pretty quick first half. I'm not going to lie. Like, that went faster than expected. As cold and painful as it is, it went faster than I thought. So
Yeah. I mean, that first half kind of raced by. I looked back, and there was a minute left in the first quarter.
Yeah, and I think it has to do with all the running going on. There haven't been any incomplete passes, any places to stop the clock. So we're really just waiting 15 minutes before these guys run back out. We'll probably more like 17 minutes, but that's the way it's going to go for now.
Yeah, and I mean, so we have a 20-minute halftime.
Yep.
So I'm going to read our sponsors.
Yeah.
And so our first sponsor is going to be Mills Tire and Tech, family-owned since 2010. Owner Brian Mills does everything, tires, auto work, engines, and he loves working on diesels, and he's here to support the Willcox Cowboys. SSVEC, Sulphur Springs Valley Electric Cooperative, serving our community. The Ed Morse Automotive Group, formerly Lawely Automotive, now serving Cochise County, and they're committed to make a long-lasting, positive relationship within the community.
Hmm.
Bowie Pecans, America's only native tree nut once again. American is pecan pie and Friday night football.
Absolutely.
Good luck, Willcox. We back you all the way at Bowie Pecan Farm. The Willcox Livestock Auction, Arizona's oldest livestock auction, serving all of Arizona and southwestern New Mexico. Good luck, Willcox football players.
And let me say something about that. Those are fun to go to. Believe it or not, you can go to those. Beautiful women, nice cars. I mean, you would never expect to go to an auction and have fun. They're actually pretty cool. Even if you're not an auctioneer or if you're not auctioning anything off, you're not buying anything, they're still fun to go and check out. So thank you to them.
And I mean, they're the oldest for a reason.
Yeah.
They've been in business for a long time.
Oh, yeah.
They're serving outside of Arizona into southwestern New Mexico.
Oh, yeah. The region, man. The region.
Another huge thank you to the Marathon Truck Stop, Willcox Express Store, proudly supporting and sponsoring all of Willcox and their youth. Stop by and see Robin, Michelle, Marie, and Carlos. And again, mention you heard it in Cool FM and receive a free 22-ounce fountain drinker coffee, as well as T&B Tire Service Willcox. We specialize in tire sales and tire repairs for passenger vehicles, semis, and farm equipment. Over 45 years of experience. Come down and see Mark Teeters at 2060 North Haskell Avenue for all your tire needs. And last but not least, Big Tex Barbecue. Always proud to support our young cowboy athletes and all they do. We're so proud of you from Big Tex, from Big Tex Barbecue Willcox.
Yeah, dude, if there's something that represents the Cowboys, it would be barbecue food as far as I can tell. And we got a little bit of a heads up by Sunday Green how to pronounce Bowie. So it's pronounced Bowie.
Bowie.
Bowie, I guess. All right, well, B-O-W-I-E is pronounced Bowie. Well, I think I've heard that before, so we're gonna pronounce it Bowie from now on.
Bowie.
Yep. Yeah, you gotta clean up the sloppy handoffs. But the thing is it's cold hands. You know, you got to have hand warmers out there. Those guys are playing like their hands are cold.
Yeah, and I mean, it's really showing with these fumbles that are just killing some of these drives.
And incomplete passes and inaccurate passes. Try throwing a ball when your hands are cold. That's a hard thing to do.
You can't even grip the ball when your hands are cold.
And the football feels different. So like, when it's warm, you can grip them a whole lot better. I'm not sure what the science is behind that, but like when it's cold, it's like all the leather just kind of like seals up. It doesn't have any real grip. The nubs on it kind of go away.
Yeah, and I mean, I think that's going to be the biggest thing is trying to fix some of these turnovers for Willcox. And, I mean, Scottsdale Prep is going to have to clean up their defense as well.
Yeah, you know, it's coming down to that. Like, you've got an unstoppable running game that's only stopped by fumbles. You've got a defense that's allowing it, but is picking they're maximizing on their turnovers. So the reality is Scottsdale Prep, they're maximizing on turnovers that Willcox has given them. You know, it's unfortunate, but it's true. Like, this has been a giveaway.
And, I mean, they took one back for a touchdown.
Yep.
And I believe that was maybe their third one.
Yep.
And so this score, realistically, could be Willcox on top 28-21 right now.
I know. Shoot, you could even say, you could honestly even say, yeah, 28-14. I don't know, maybe 35-14. But, yeah, when the Willcox running game, I haven't seen anything like it in 2A football. Now, last year I saw Sebastian Lopez, I believe. Was he the wide receiver for Tombstone? Who was the – there was
Malachi
a –
Keller.
Malachi, that's the guy.
The Matrix Keller.
Dude, I am telling you, like, that kid was a real athlete. I was impressed.
That kid is athletic in everything he does.
Yeah, like you, kind of, except he's tall, though. Good Lord.
He is tall.
Yeah, I watched him play basketball. I've watched him play a lot of sports. Anyway, what I was going with was that, like, he is a top-notch athlete. The very first game that I ever did, he only had 3 receptions for 160 yards and 3 touchdowns. You're averaging 50 yards per reception.
That's a Randy Moss stat.
Yeah, that's exactly what it was. It's exactly what it was. That's what Randy did in his very first game. Yeah, that was a lot of fun to watch. A Bowie. Thank you, Todd. It's Bowie. Yes, we got it. It's Bowie. Everybody's letting us know. It's all... Okay, we will apologize. Yes, the Bowie stop. We will pronounce it correctly. And hopefully...
Bowie.
Yeah. I can't remember how we were even pronouncing it before.
I'm going to have to go down there now.
Todd,
I'm going to have to apologize. I'm going to have to go spend $100 there.
Yep. Go there and thank them. Yeah, we got a lot of people in from Scottsdale. That's really cool.
I'm going to try to get score updates from around the county right now. My last check-in was Bisbee was on top 19-6, I believe. And Boyna was up 7-0.
All right.
So by now, it's probably the scores have expanded a little bit. That was still in the first quarter of this game. So we're going to check on the Boyna score. But Berean Academy, we won last night, so now we move on to the second round of playoffs. We're going up to Surprise this week to play Imagine Surprise.
Good for you guys. Dude, you guys have been so impressive that everybody around the community, people have been talking about ALA moving up to 2A, and I'm like, why aren't we talking about Berean going up to 2A? I mean, you guys play so well. I could totally imagine you guys playing on a field like this on a Friday.
That's really just Coach Hampton. I mean, I've played there for 2.5 years, and he coaches us up like to be men. He coaches us up to be men as well as athletes, and he does a great job at it.
He sure does. Yeah, we've interviewed him multiple times. He's always very humble, very kind. He has authority, but he brings his authority with love, you know? Like he isn't out there screaming because he likes to scream. He gets out there, and when he gives you instruction, well, that's really more of what it is. When he's giving you hard instruction, it's instruction. You have to realize that he's doing his best to make you a better football player.
And it looks like Boyne is losing right now to Cienega, 14-15.
No!
With 1 minute left in the second quarter.
Oh, my gosh. Buena is losing to Cienega. That could knock them out of the playoffs altogether. Oh, they were not seeing that.
I mean, in Coach Thomas, he coaches up a good squad. I mean,
for sure.
They have a lot of great juniors, great seniors on the roster.
Oh, yeah.
And so, I mean, going into halftime, if you're down, Coach Thomas is going to be fired up, and he's going to give a great speech. And then the leaders on that team are going to take over, kind of like what I'm expecting from Willcox right now.
Yep.
And, I mean, Boyne is still in this game. Boyne can still win this
for
game.
For sure, it's a one-point game.
Run away with it. We saw them hang up 70 on Desert View.
Yep. And the thing is, they've got a really strong running game, kind of like this. I mean, this is kind of a different level. Like, Buena isn't putting up 7 yards per carry, but their offensive line is super tough. Scrappy's a really great running back. Lujan, fullback, and he's kind of like a tailback too. But man, I'm telling you, that guy can actually hit really hard. I mean, as far as a running back goes, you don't want to get in front of a kid like either of those guys. Scrappy squats like 450 or something like that. Sick.
Yeah, I mean, I played with Scrappy growing up. Him and Elias Dyson were on the same team together.
Oh, no.
We lost one game that year to Benson, and it was our last game of the year. But, I mean, he's been like that since he was a little kid.
They said he started so we interviewed his older brother who went to Western – oh, shoot. He went to a college
New Mexico year. Highlands.
New Mexico Adrian. Highlands, Adrian. Yes. That's right. So we interviewed him. He was telling us, you know, Scrappy actually got him into weightlifting. He was like, I got into football because my little brother was in football, but he was outlifting me. So Adrian was like, I didn't want to be showed up by my brother. Robin Morrow, we will definitely say your name Morrow like tomorrow. Tomorrow, all right. Morrow like tomorrow.
And I mean, Scrappy and Lujan, they're in the backfield every game getting over 100 yards each.
Oh, yeah. And you know they've got other running backs that could put up numbers too. That's the other funny thing is like, their backup, Charlie Price, is a really good player, too. I mean, if he was on my squad, he'd probably be starting. But, like, there are so many players on that roster. Like, who gets playing time and who doesn't, you know?
And, I mean, they're just playmakers all over that field.
Oh, yeah. Charlie ran some kid over in that first game. I felt so bad for him. That kid, I'm sure he was just blowing snot out his nose just after he got hit by Charlie in the end zone. Oh my gosh, it was hilarious.
I remember one time in eighth grade, Charlie and I were playing together. We're on the same 7-on-7 team. And he ran into me and one of my braces for my tooth went through my lip.
Oh, yeah, I got one of those right here. My bottom lip though. Oh, every time I've got this retainer in, so you can tell that I don't speak very clearly sometimes. Well, I didn't realize until I got this retainer that back in the day when I was in like fifth grade, I got popped in the face just like you're talking about, but it wasn't a helmet. I got hit in the face by like a soccer ball. The braces went right through my lower lip and they called my parents. Everybody was freaking out. Didn't even go home. But you know, Generation X, we basically ate glass. So
I have one more playoff game that I want to talk about, and that's LA Sierra Vista last night.
Yes, what happened?
So they lost 44-0 to Skyline Gila, and that's the team they started off their season playing in week one.
Yeah.
And, I mean, that's a tough blow, but, I mean, ALA, a first-year team making the playoffs.
Definitely impressive, for sure.
And so, I mean, Coach Krause, he has a foundation to build with. He has a freshman playing quarterback.
Yeah, he does. And his son plays for your team, right? Does his son play for your squad or does he play on his own squad?
He plays on his own
squad. Okay, yeah. Good linebacker, and he's a wrestler too, I want to say. Yeah, I'll tell you this. I found a lot of athletes in my day that where you can cross train, and wrestling is actually one of the top ones. It's baseball and wrestling are like the two ones where if I wanted to have a lineman, I would send my kids to wrestling. If I wanted to have a quarterback or a receiver, I'd put him in baseball, you know?
Yeah, and I mean, there are just so many sports that we have dual threat athletes of in Cochise County. I mean, we have Sebastian Lopez, great football player, great basketball player. And so
that kid's a freak on the basketball court.
I mean, we have some great athletes in Cochise County just all around.
Oh, yeah. And in track, too, I want to say he was a high jumper. And Weikelt won the state championship in the shot put.
Weikelt.
Yeah, that kid's a monster.
Yeah, that kid's a beast. Yeah, that kid is a beast.
We're going to be interviewing him hopefully when he comes home from school. We're talking about that happening already. So we interviewed him. Coach Jared and I interviewed him for a radio show on Cool FM. Good kid, good dad. You know, that's a lot of fun to like hang out with those folks.
Yeah, I mean they're great people, great family.
Yep. Wrestling is an elite sport for every position in football. I would agree. I'm not sure. Well, yeah, you know, I think that would help a quarterback. I'm not sure it helps the kicker, but you know what? There's always got to be one guy that doesn't, things don't fit with. Put the kicker in soccer, right? But yeah, thank you, Tony. You're totally right. Wrestlers are the, we had wrestlers throughout my, we had better wrestlers on our football team, and we did really, really well with those wrestlers than we did with the guys that were coached by, that were like the head coach's son. So we had the head coach's football player was our quarterback. He was pretty good, but the wrestlers just would beat the snot out of them. They were all super tough.
Yeah, I mean, I know so many wrestlers that are also football players, and they're also stud football players.
They're great tacklers.
It's one of those things that translates so well.
Oh, yeah. Oh, on defense, for sure. I didn't even think about that. When I was in wrestling, I didn't wrestle for very long, but we did this fireman carry where you put a guy over your shoulders and you carry him up a hill. Oh, my gosh. I'm 6 feet tall. I was 6 feet tall when I was a freshman in high school. I'm telling you, the taller you are, the longer your limbs, it doesn't work as well. Like, you have to be super strong if you're tall. Yeah. It's so hard. Like, the shorties, the guys that were, like, 5'10", well, not even 5'10", 5'5", those dudes could carry big guys. It was incredible. All right, it looks like we got about 2 minutes left before the kickoff. Guys are stretching out on each sideline.
And so Scottsdale Prep, they're going to start with the ball here.
Yep. So you got to wonder, will Willcox come out with something special on the kickoff? Will they do an onside kick?
I feel like they're going to just keep it normal, to be honest. I mean, their kicker has a leg.
Yeah.
He can kick this ball down to the 1 yard line.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I feel like he's going to try to force their hand to be in a bad field position, bad spot on the field for this offense. And they're going to try to create turnovers in the second half. And I think that's going to be key to this first drive, is trying to create a turnover.
Yeah, for sure.
And I mean, this defensive line has played great. They've been getting pressure on these quarterbacks, forcing them to roll out for Scottsdale Prep.
Yep. Yeah, they're not passing. Neither team has passed very well. But I think Willcox's defense has kept Scottsdale Prep from passing, whereas I think Willcox decided not to throw the ball anymore, except for in the last two plays of the half.
Yeah, and I mean, I just don't think Willcox necessarily has as well of a passing offense as maybe Scottsdale Prep. Scottsdale Prep, it looks like their whole offense is surrounded around the pass.
True. It looks like Willcox is just an absolute beast at the run game. And honestly, I think it has a lot to do with the linemen. I'm watching so much motion with those guys running the ball. It's very impressive.
And it really looks like Wilcox's pass game is just an extension of the run game.
Yep.
And so Scottsdale Prep is going to be back to return. Wilcox kicking the ball off here. And this is going to bring the second half to a start. And I'm excited to see what Willcox can do here in the second half.
What's the adjustment?
I mean, I think offensively, I think you're just shooting yourself in the foot. I think you can keep the same scheme.
You obviously can just run.
Just forcing less turnovers among yourself.
Yep.
And so Willcox is going to kick this ball here.
Oh,
and that ball's going
deep.
And they're going to have number 14 for Scottsdale Prep, handing it off to number 11, and that really did not work.
We used to do that exact same play, but it worked. So what you do is that point man that catches the ball, you hold it on your hip so the kick team can't tell where if you've handed the ball off or not. And you hold it, you hold your hands on your hip as if you still have the ball for maybe a couple steps. And you're trying to draw a hit while the other person runs the ball. So.
And we saw a play like that in the Bisbee Tombstone game, actually. Bisbee did that and handed it off and scored.
Oh, I love it.
And so now Scottsdale Prep is going to take over. And there's going to be first down for the Spartans here. And they're going to look to get going here.
Look at that weird setup.
This is the weirdest formation I've ever seen. Direct snap to the running back, though. And he's going to be swallowed behind the line.
Yep.
That's going to be about second and 14, maybe. Second and 13.
Yeah, that's rough.
And that play design's a little questionable, running it to the short side of the field. You're running it basically where you have no room to run.
Yeah. I mean, Scottsdale Prep had to make some changes, too. You wonder, maybe they didn't make any changes. Maybe they thought that this was an offense. You know, maybe they felt like they were comfortable enough to not make any deep changes. But this is such a weird formation. What are they doing? I haven't seen this before.
So it looks like they can pretty much do everything out of this formation,
yeah,
is what I'm seeing.
They're snapping to the right or the left.
And they don't have a quarterback truly behind the center. They're both lining up behind the guards.
Yeah, exactly.
And so,
they're lining up behind the guards.
And so you just kind of have to guess where this ball's going.
Oh, my gosh. That's kind of a wildcat. It's an interesting adaptation to the wildcat formation. I love it.
I'm going to have to see if Coach Hampton's watching this because I want him to try to do that.
I know. You guys do. You guys are shotgun all the time.
That just looks so much fun. And so they're going to go back to their normal offense, it looks like, having their quarterback under center.
Yeah.
But they're going to pass the ball here.
Oh, they're blitzing. Oh, they got them. I think they got a false start on the offense. The linebacker came up to it showed blitz, and it scared the snot out of that guard.
And
it looked like he was going
to
kill him.
I'm almost willing to bet that they were motioning this slot receiver across, and that backside linebacker was following the motion to the line and then blitzing off that backside,
yeah,
and that lineman just got anxious.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's a great analysis. Good job. The score is 21-14. Scottsdale Prep with the lead with 10 minutes left in the third quarter. Thank you, Justin.
And so now they're lining up in the spread again.
Oh.
It's third and, I believe, 15 here. And so they're motioning their receiver. And he's going to be open on the post, and it's almost intercepted by Remington Todd, almost coming down from safety and intercepting that.
Dude, that hit him in both hands. That, in my head, I'm seeing an interception. You know, they've been really good on defense, but their hands are not. You wonder why they don't throw the ball, right? You know?
Yeah, and I mean, yeah.
If you're throwing it to dudes and hits them in both hands and they can't bring it in, no matter what their position, maybe you just stick with the run.
But, I mean, that's a great defensive drive from Willcox.
Oh, for
it's
sure.
Fourth down, and now they're forcing them to punt when this punter does not look like he has a leg from what I saw in the one punt earlier.
Yeah.
And so
nice
Landon
block.
Ward setting a block, and that's going to go into Scottsdale Prep Spartan territory.
Yep. They got it on the other side of the 50. Good job.
And, I mean, that's a great defensive drive by Willcox. They stopped them. And now they're going to take over on offense. And so this Willcox drive is going to be brought to you by Mills Tire and Tech. Family owned since 2010. Owner Brian Mills does everything, tires, auto work, engines, and has a love for diesels. And he says, good luck, Cowboys. We're with you all the way.
If he's got diesel work, I got some cars for him, my man. We'll be sending you some work. Thank you so much.
And Willcox will take over on this first down. And they're going to motion Landon Ward across, and it looks like it could have been encroachment.
It was.
It could have been encroachment on the defense. And that linebacker just jumped over too far.
Yeah. Man.
And it looked like they were trying to do the same thing Willcox did last drive, and it just backfired.
I thought exactly the same thing.
But I don't think he was going to blitz.
Yeah, he was faking it.
I think he was gonna bluff the blitz and drop back. Because they cannot blitz him. They need him for the run support.
Oh, for sure. Imagine, like, one kickout block, and it's a touchdown.
And so now they're running the ball.
Jeez.
Remington Todd getting. I believe that's 15 yards on the carry.
Oh my gosh. That interior, that the offensive line is carrying the team.
And I mean, really, this line, having a great line, you can build your skill guys around them. Mm-hmm. And that's kind of what Willcox looks like they've done this year, is build these skill guys around this line and teach their running backs some patience. And so they handed it off down the middle to Cuevas. At least it looks like he got
7?
Maybe 10 yards.
Gosh.
And that's a first down.
Wow.
Straight down the middle, 10 yards for Ismael Cuevas.
Okay, warm up your hands. You were getting close to the end zone. Like, as soon as they get inside the 10, they better start breathing on their fingers because we don't want another fumble.
And I hope they have hand warmers in that locker room to keep these fumbles from happening.
Yeah, right? Oh, they're blitzing up the middle there. Look at that.
And they're going to push forward for about 5 yards.
They still got yardage with all that blitzing. Yeah, you got to.
A stack the box. Every gap is filled, and you're still fighting for 5 yards.
Yeah. I mean, you wonder. I mean, that's not just the offensive line. That's a strong running back. But, like, as a group, this is a well-oiled machine. You got to hope that they can put this in the end zone and tie this game up.
Yeah, I mean, this is a great offense I'm watching tonight on both sides of the ball. And so Landon Ward cutting it inside, and he is not going down, and then he's forced to go down.
Yeah. I think he lost his footing. Like, he got spun, and then he went down to one hand, and I thought he was going to get back up, and then his knee just barely hit the ground.
It looked like his cleat slipped out of the turf.
Yeah, yeah.
And I thought he could have taken that in for a touchdown, to be honest.
I did, too. I thought he was going to go. Man, he is such a strong runner.
He's elusive, and he's well-balanced.
Yeah, the balance. It's, you don't go after one contact. You don't go when, you know, you're carrying weight or someone's pulling on you. You don't go down on
so this
contact.
Is third and four. And it's going down the middle. And I believe that could be a first down, maybe.
Yeah, that's close.
If not, it's going to be fourth and one.
Yep. I
think. Just short of the first down.
Fourth and one.
Fourth down.
Oh, man.
And I finally came up with a comparison for Landon Ward in my
mind.
Alvin Kamara.
Yes. Alvin Kamara is a tall, thick dude.
Alvin Kamara.
As much of a – so he's a big receiving back. But, man, yeah, he can run up the middle with speed and strength. Good balance. Good
Watching
idea.
Him run reminds me of this play when he was playing the Packers a few years ago.
Okay.
And he jumps over everybody, but he's, like, jogging. He looks like he's jogging down the sideline. That's kind of what I see out of Landon Ward.
Elusive speed.
And so this is first down, first and goal. They gave him the first down. And so now they're going to try to score.
Wow.
And number 12, Remington Todd, gaining 5 yards. And it's second and goal from the 2-yard line. And thank the Lord Willcox has not fumbled yet. I'm not going to jinx it. I refuse to jinx it.
They got this. They got the hand warmers in there. They're stretching their legs. They're ready to get in.
They're warm. They're warm now.
Yep.
The locker room warmed them up just enough.
I hope so. Oh, man. Goal line. Can they
and
do
this
it?
This crowd is energetic.
Pitch.
Landon Ward.
He's going
in.
Not good. Touchdown, Cowboys.
So the Warden punches one in.
Dude.
He's a clutch time.
Yep, had to get it. Had to get it. Third quarter, and they got to get this extra point.
And so Wilcox's first drive on offense takes up half the third quarter.
Yep. And, you know, we haven't seen them pitch the ball yet, so that was kind of interesting. On a cold day when people's hands aren't working very well, they trusted Landon to catch the ball and run it in.
And so they're going to go for the extra point here. And that's going to be good, and that's going to tie this ball game up.
Oh, yep, hit a car. They had someone standing out in front of the trucks this time. They had two people, but it went over the wall, and it hit two of the cars. It would be kind of fun to see.
A double doink.
Yeah, double doink. It would be fun if they had, like, car alarms on, but, you know.
Hearing the car alarms.
That would be hysterical. Tie game, 21-21 with 5 minutes, 37 seconds left in the third quarter.
And this is really what I was expecting out of two-way playoff football.
Oh, yeah.
And Scottsdale Prep going into this game has only lost one game.
They are so good. You can totally see it here.
They're the 8 seed going in. Wilcox is the 9 seed.
Wow. How did they get matched up against each other? 8 and a 9 seed? That's ridiculous.
8 and a 9 seed.
Oh, my gosh. Usually you put, like, the 9 seed versus the 1 seed, but...
So now Wilcox is kicking this ball off, and that's a solid kick. And it's going to be fielded by number 11 for Scottsdale Prep, and he's going to try to hit the sideline.
Ooh, wow.
And get tackled with his own teammate into the pile, and he's going to be a little slow to get up.
Oh, my gosh. He lit him up. And I hope he's okay.
I think that knocked the air out of him. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, he's on his feet. He's up. He's good.
And so now Scottsdale Prep is taking over on offense. And this first down is going to be brought to you by Sulphur Springs Valley Electric Cooperative, serving our community. And I want to see if they can put something together this drive, because now they need to score.
Yeah, they do. Oh, no, they lost their receiver. A piece of his helmet came off. They're fixing his helmet, so they had to send in the backup.
Oh, man.
I know. Dude, I'm telling you, when your equipment goes away, we would tell a guy just to take the helmet from the next guy over. My head was huge, though, so nobody stole my helmet.
Last night, that actually happened to us. One of our defensive linemen's helmet had an issue. And there's the screen.
Oh, my gosh.
And they sniffed that out.
Yeah.
I heard the ball get tipped at the line from all the way up here.
Yeah, that wide receiver took a shot to the head, though. I hope he's okay. What number is he? Number 18?
Number 14.
Oh, number 14. Yeah, he took a knee off the top of his head. And I'll tell you, that is just as bad as getting hit with a helmet. A knee like that can create some serious force. Like, there's no punch that can do as much damage as a knee.
Yeah, and I mean, he took the hit. He seems like he's okay. There's no wobble. There's nothing.
Yeah, thankfully. He was kind of holding his helmet, but now he's out on the field. So he's good, I guess. Score is 21-21, so I'll let you guess who's winning.
So now they're lining up, two out wide, two in the backfield. And they're sending it to the receiver in the flats. And that's complete. That's going to bring up 3rd and 4.
Oh, man.
And that quarterback has a rifle.
Yeah, he's throwing well.
He got that ball there in like a half a second.
Yep. Yeah, that was a nice high-velocity ball brought in with both hands, knocked out of bounds, stopping the clock. You know, good play.
Yeah, and so this is going to bring up, I believe, 3rd and 5 for Scottsdale Prep, and they're going to have to get this ball beyond the sticks now, or they're going to have to punt here. So they're going to line up three out wide, two in the backfield.
Weird formation. What's going on here? They're yelling at, he's got something going on with his gear.
He's got a cut.
No, they're taking out their starting tackle on 3rd down.
He's got a cut, so he has to come out.
You might call a timeout. I wouldn't call a timeout, but our team might call a timeout. Oh, they're switching the left tackle to the right side.
So now they've got to wrap it up.
I'm telling
and
you.
And that's complete.
Yeah, I think he got it.
And I mean, I thought that might have been a roll play considering, like a roll right play considering right. They switched the tackles.
True, yeah. And he just stayed in the pocket. Yeah, he stayed in the pocket. He was looking to the right.
And these DBs, they have to be ready for this pass.
Yeah.
That's really what they've been doing all night. And they're open for the majority of these plays.
Yeah, that's right. Like, outside of the couple. Actually, Landon's been playing some really good defensive back. He's got his hand on a couple of those. Oh, penalty already.
And that's caught, and he's going to go out of bounds, forced out of bounds. but there will be a flag on the play.
Yeah, the referee isn't walking up. He's like, nope. That's coming back. Oh, man.
And I wonder what this flag is going to be.
Dude, if you are the player, don't yell at the referees. This is one thing I've been seeing. I'm like, if, oh, false start, offense. Don't
illegal
interact.
Illegal formation.
Illegal, yeah, you know what? Yeah, that makes sense because the wide receiver wasn't lined up on the line of scrimmage. Okay, I was thinking there might be a tight end, but I wasn't paying a lot of attention.
And we will replay first down.
Oh, man.
And so, oh, man, that's a killer.
Yeah, on first down, after you barely got first down on that last one, now you got to go 20 yards.
That is a huge killer for this offense. And really, I mean, Wilcox's defense, they've played a solid game so far, but right here is whenever they really need to come up and get a stop.
Absolutely.
And so they're lining up three out wide. Here comes the screen. And number 14 is going to get met with a swarm of Willcox defenders.
Yep, they wrapped up his legs, and then someone came in high and knocked him over.
It looked like there were about eight of them in there.
Yeah, the defense, the Willcox defense is swarming. That is another bonus. I don't think that the play clock operator is doing things correctly. There's been a couple times where the ball hasn't gone out of bounds and it hasn't been an incomplete pass, but the clock doesn't run. It should be a running clock like it is right now. 3:45 left in the third quarter.
So second and 11 for the Spartans. And they're lining up max protect, so it's going to be a shot here.
Oh!
And that was almost intercepted, but that's going to be caught. Still short of the first down, luckily. But it really looked like that DB was coming up to get the shot.
Oh, my gosh. So you got to wonder. They knew that ball was coming. I couldn't tell if he was going to go for the ball or the hit. Because a lot of times you can time that hit right when that ball's arriving, knock that ball loose. But so you're trying to figure out which one's a safer play. Go after the ball, go after the player. And that time he went after the ball. They completed the pass, but not for much.
And so this is third and one for Scottsdale Prep, motioning their running back out, and this quarterback's going to try to run with it. And he's going to get a first down, and Landon Ward's going to make the tackle on the sideline. But this quarterback is fast for being 6'2", 205 pounds.
Yeah, he's a hustler.
And so this first down is going to be brought to you by the Ed Morse Automotive Group, now serving Cochise County. They're committed to making a long-lasting, positive relationship within the community. Stop by Ed Morse Automotive Group today.
Ed Morse, thank you so much, man. They're paying the bills for a lot of our stuff, thank God. Good people. Ooh, a little
bounce. And so that's a little flat pass.
Yeah.
And he's going to get out of bounds, gaining about 2 to 3 yards.
Not much. Ooh, Bisbee's up 25-20 on Camp Verde.
And that's a lot closer of a game than I thought it would be.
Way closer. Dude, if Camp Verde beats the Bisbee, I mean, that would shake up the playoffs big time.
Yeah, that could definitely change some things in the bracket.
I've been thinking that like I said earlier, the championship comes through Cochise County. So I think either Willcox or Bisbee are going to take it. But, man, if you're only up by five, you got to wonder.
Yeah, and I mean, I think that's a real possibility this year. We have some studs in Cochise County.
Oh, Landon Ward's a wrestler, too. That makes sense. That's why he's got such great balance. Ooh, up. Oh, penalty on the defense.
False start on the offense.
Oh, was it? Oh.
False start on the offense.
Yeah.
We have a technical false start on the
And so that's going to move this ball back 5 yards. That's going to make it about third and 13.
5 yards.
Second and 13, excuse me.
So, is there a Joe on this squad for Willcox?
A Joe?
Joe, is his name, is there a player named Joe? Smooth Joe, is that what they keep calling
him? There's Joseph Sanchez.
Okay, they're probably talking about him. Smooth Joe Sanchez?
Joseph Sanchez.
All right. Well, he's a wrestler too, apparently. We're getting a lot of comments from Willcox. Thank you for checking in, everybody.
And I mean, that's the Willcox support.
Oh, he's a quarterback. Joe is the quarterback.
Joseph Sanchez.
Yep. Right, shotgun formation. Ooh, Bisbee just put up another touchdown.
And there's a fake toss. Tip pass to the tight end. And he tipped it to himself. Yeah. He tipped it into himself and caught it.
Four on the play.
And so that's going to bring up 3rd and 9. 3rd and 10, excuse me.
120 people checking in, dude. Tons of people are watching from Willcox.
It's Willcox, I'm telling you. Yep. These Cowboys are the pride of Willcox.
Oh, my gosh. No doubt.
Everybody loves the Willcox Cowboys.
Okay, number 11 is Smooth Joe Sanchez.
Smooth Joe Sanchez. And it looks like Smooth Joe Sanchez is on defense, too.
Oh, my gosh. You know he's important. Pump fake.
Oh, and it's a deep pass down the sideline. Incomplete, but there will be a pass interference call.
Yeah, he didn't turn around.
Pass interference.
I'm not sure he made contact, though. So there are rules like face guarding and stuff like that. You got to wonder if that was...
You have to turn around to track this ball.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you're almost guaranteed to get the flag called on you regardless.
Yeah, that's unfortunate.
And that's a killer.
Yeah. 1 minute, 17 seconds left in the third quarter. Score is 21-21.
Jeez.
How warm do you think it is right now? 30 degrees?
It's got to be probably about the 40s.
Oh,
I'll give it the 40s. It's 53 degrees.
53? Yeah.
53.
Good gravy. It feels like it's below zero. My toes have already fallen off.
So you're running it with this quarterback, and he's tripped on his own lineman.
Oh, no.
Tripped up on his own lineman.
That sucks.
That's a killer.
Yeah. Getting your footwork right is a real hard thing for a quarterback, and tripping down your lineman happens all the time. What's worse is getting stepped on by your lineman and they like crush a toe.
Oh yeah, those are terrible.
Oh, especially when it's cold. I played in Washington State. A lot of cold weather. I'm telling you, I've had my feet stepped on so many times.
So now it's 2nd and 12 here. And they're gonna pass it out. And
oh my gosh!
What a catch.
I was tracking the ball to go out of bounds.
What
a
catch.
And he snatched that with one hand.
So that's number 84 for Scottsdale Prep with back-to-back one-hand catches.
Very cool.
He tipped the ball to himself with one hand, and then he makes that catch on the sideline. That's Braxton Whittington, the sophomore.
Awesome. We got a bunch of people. Some people checking in from Oregon. Some people checking in from Phoenix. Thank you. Very cool. That's the end of the third. 21-21.
So Willcox won that quarter 7-0.
Yeah. Really.
So they need to stop the score here, and they need to score again.
Yeah, bend but don't break. I'm telling you, can they do it? I don't know.
Scottsdale Prep has had a great offensive run this third quarter, though.
Oh, yeah. Scottsdale Prep is a tough, tough team. They've only lost one game all season. Willcox tying them up right now.
And, I mean, Willcox is just showing they can compete with the 2A big dogs.
Oh, yeah.
They are one of the 2A big dogs.
They really are. They really, really are. It doesn't matter that we're from Cochise County out in the sticks. Man, we play good ball. I tell you, tough kids everywhere.
And so this fourth quarter is going to be brought to you by Bowie Pecans, America's only native tree nut, with American pie, as American as pecan pie in Friday Night Football. Good luck, Willcox. We back you all the way from Bowie Pecan Farm.
Yeah, all right. Oh, my least favorite song of all time. Who's going to barf for me? Bob, Bob, barf.
And so now, Scottsdale Prep, they're taking over from the 20-yard line. And this is third down, third and about four. And so they need to convert here.
Yep.
And they're going to run a play-action pass.
Great defense!
By number six, Caleb Cook.
Dude, what a great defensive play. I mean, if that quarterback had had any more time, he would have completed that pass.
And that's the perfect time for a play like that.
That's what you need.
To bring out fourth and four.
And they are going to kick. Can they hit from here?
They're going to kick the ball?
I know. It looks like they got the kicking team out. Maybe not. Nope.
No, the quarterback's bringing the play call in.
That's what it is. Oh,
man.
My gosh.
I mean, I think their kicker has the boot. He's hitting cars back here.
Yeah, he's hitting from deep. And he kicks the ball really high.
And so this is fourth and four for Scottsdale Prep. And I know exactly where this ball is going. And it's incomplete.
Wow! Wilcox, turnover on downs in the first.
That is a huge stop.
Oh, dude, that's the biggest play of the game so far.
That's a huge stop.
Yeah, that's massive.
A fourth down stop in the red zone for Willcox, and now they're going to take over. And that play is going to be crucial to the end of this game. And it looks like the injured linebacker is coming back on the field from earlier.
Oh, good for him. Good for him, yep. So,
I believe that is him.
Oh, man. I'm looking forward to this fourth quarter, man.
This fourth quarter can make or break this game for Willcox.
Absolutely. Tie game, 21-21, 11:52 left in the game.
So Willcox is going to get the ball on first down.
Oh, wow.
And there goes Cuevas. And he's going to keep trying to fight. There were five people in that pile, and he was not going down.
Nope. And you could also see that he's holding onto the ball with both hands.
Like, and that's a strong run.
Oh, yeah. Strong run. I mean, he could probably have carried another 10 pounds. Ooh, someone's coming off the field with something going on with his
leg. And
that
looks like the nose tackle.
Oh, man. Oh, if their starting defensive line are coming out, what are you going to do? You could run right over them.
And so this is first down for the Cowboys. First and 10 to Landon Ward. Down the middle.
Sheesh.
And it looked like he got a first down. That's
Sanchez gives to Ward.
First down for the Cowboys. 10 yards down the middle.
First down, Willcox.
11 minutes left in the game. In the playoffs. Nine? Wait, what ranking are these teams?
Nine. Willcox is ranked 9.
Okay.
Scottsdale Prep is ranked 8.
Oh, my gosh. What a matchup. So evenly matched. 21-21 in the fourth.
And this game has been nothing short of exciting.
Oh, it's been amazing. Willcox can't stop running the ball.
And so it's going to Landon Ward. He's being patient.
Super patient.
And he's just not going down.
Are you kidding me?
Is that another first down for Willcox?
I mean,
first down for Willcox.
Great job. Nice.
Willcox is really just running this ball all over this team.
I think Willcox has a chance to win this. I mean, we've been saying that all along, but I think that they could put this in the end zone and actually put this game away.
I think it's going to be crucial for their defense to just clutch up right now. If they do score, for this defense to really focus in and stop this team from scoring this drive.
Yeah. Getting the play from the quarterback.
Smooth Joe. And Smooth Joe's going to keep it himself. And he's going to try to lay a hit.
Yeah, he ran that kid over.
He's going to lay a hit.
Now, that play looked like a broken play. I think the young man that was confused on the play before the play started was the same one that ran the wrong direction on that play.
Yeah.
Number 13, I believe.
I mean, Smooth Joe Sanchez, he did a great job keeping the ball and being aware of maybe a broken play.
They didn't give him any forward progress. I thought he got about a yard on that play.
I did think he got about a yard.
That's okay, though.
And so this is second and 10 for the Cowboys. And they're going to hand this ball off to Remington Todd, getting around the edge.
Yeah.
And that's going to be a game of about 12. And that's going to be a Willcox first down.
Very cool.
And they're just driving this ball down the field.
Oh, yeah. Thank you to all of our sponsors. Thank you for checking in. All the, wow, we're up to 136 people. That's the second biggest game I've broadcast this year.
And so right now, this three-headed snake in the backfield, Remington Todd, Ismael Cuevas, and Landon Ward is just punishing this defense. And speaking of Landon Ward, there he is.
Man, what a great play.
Seven yards down the middle.
I mean, if you're on defense, I mean, that would be just heart-wrenching. Just this guy's running the ball over and over and can't be stopped.
Especially when your season's on the line right
now.
Yeah,
oh, man. I mean, it's just slipping away. They got to hope for a fumble or something. But Willcox is just moving the ball at will.
So this is second and four for the Cowboys, and they're going to hand it off to Cuevas. Cuevas going to the outside.
He's got so much room.
And he's going to get hit by the safety out of bounds. And that's going to be a first down for the Cowboys.
Great job.
Wow. And he was quick around that edge.
Yeah,
I will say, he was running around that edge quick.
So I didn't think the defensive back had a really good angle at it. And he was just running full sprint at that sideline, that Willcox sideline. He was just trying to get as much distance between him and the next player.
Yeah, and I mean, he did a great job at it. He had a quick burst of speed coming out of the backfield and going all the way down to the right sideline. And so now they're going to run it with him again, reward him.
Jeez.
And he's spinning, and he's going to go down inside the 10.
Another broken tackle, man.
And now Willcox cannot afford to fumble the ball.
Nope, they can't do it. That could be the end of the game. I mean, shoot, that's what happened last time. Or not last time. Last time they scored.
So now Willcox is going to have the ball inside the red zone. And they're going to need to punch this in. And really, I've only seen three or four pass attempts out of Willcox.
Yeah.
So I don't think they're going to pass it here.
Yeah, passing game hasn't gone so well.
It's going to Ward.
No, it was a play action.
And it's a fumble.
No! No! Oh, my gosh.
And that is the worst time for a fumble to happen.
The third fumble inside the 15-yard line.
And it looked like there may have just been a miscommunication on the handoff.
Yeah. I mean, that was, man, that's heartbreaking. That's heartbreaking for me to feel. Shoot.
That could end Wilcox's season if Scottsdale, that play right there could end Wilcox's season if Scottsdale Prep can score. But I do trust Wilcox's defense. They've only given up two touchdowns defensively this entire game.
Yep.
So I do trust them to get a stop here.
Yeah, you know, the Wilcox defense is definitely the one defense that's playing better. They've played better so far. But, man, Scottsdale Prep, good offense. They've got a decent passing game, decent running game. They can spread the ball out. Oh, a flag on the play.
Is that going to be a delay of game?
Yeah.
So it was going to be a delay of game, and then he called the timeout.
So that's kind of a neat little thing that referees will allow. Even though the clock runs out, they will kind of ask you, do you want to use your timeout? And a coach can kind of come in and say yeah or no.
Yeah, and so, I mean, now Wilcox's defense is really going to have to play a great game.
Yep. So one of my favorite things to do is answer the phone and just let it play out. Just let someone sit on the other side of the phone and, yeah, they're not saying anything.
And so we want to take a second to bring you this timeout that's going to be brought to you by the Willcox Livestock Auction.
Yeah, get
Arizona's oldest livestock auction, serving all of Arizona in Southwestern New Mexico, and they say, good luck tonight, Cowboys.
Dude, let's go out and buy a steer. Let's go buy some steer.
Some steer.
Yeah.
I'm ready to buy some steer. And so now Wilcox's defense is going to have to take over the field.
Oh, they're rolling right.
And he's going to be open, making two men miss, and he's going down the sideline. And he's going to score. He's going to score on the first play of the drive, and I'm not going to lie, that's the best possible thing Wilcox could have.
Yeah?
Wow. Because now you put the ball back in the hands of your offense.
True.
And if Wilcox can block this kick, all they need is a score and an extra point to seal the game.
Unreal. One play, number 14 running down the sideline.
And that had to have been the play of the game.
Yep. Yeah. That's a great play.
He broke two tackles and then did the race down the sideline.
Nobody can catch him.
And so now they're going to have to try to block this kick.
Oh! And it's blocked! Did they?
They blocked the kick.
Wow! They blocked another kick. The
they
score.
Blocked the kick.
Dude, so if they bring the...
This is a ball game.
This is it. If they can score a touchdown and put their extra point in, they win this game.
This is a ball game now.
Holy smokes. I would not be happy with that. Yeah, the coaches, special teams coach and the head coach are yelling at each other right now. What happened? No blocking? I mean, you two blocked kicks? That's a lot of block kicks.
So now Wilcox just has to score the ball here. They have 6 minutes, 49 seconds.
Yep. Yeah, they've been putting the ball inside. They've had the ball inside the 20 more than three times, and they fumbled the ball. They scored the other two times.
And I believe, really, it just comes down to cold weather. In warm weather,
really
this
is.
Will be a completely different game.
It totally. I 100% agree. Yeah, I always talk about altitude training. We live in Cochise County, so the altitude actually helps when you move down here.
And that is a great
kick. Big kick.
And so that's going to be fielded by Remington Todd, and he's going. And so that he's going to go down at the 19, and they're going to need some explosive runs here. But they have to make sure that they're not running out the clock.
Nope.
They have to make sure that they're using their timeouts wisely.
Yeah. Hopefully they don't need to use a timeout. I'm a big fan of holding on to your timeouts, even if it's painful when it comes to the fourth quarter. But, you know, it is the fourth quarter. If you need to use it, you use it.
And so we're going to see if Wilcox here can score this ball and try to tie this game up.
Yeah. Can't. They've got nearly 7 minutes. They could definitely run this ball down the field.
Ouch! And he's met in the backfield.
Ouch!
By Scottsdale Prep, and I heard that hit from up here. That was a hard hit.
I'm not sure I'd be dancing around after a tackle on first down, but because that's motivation material. They've been running on you all night long, and you're gonna dance around on the sidelines.
That's one stop.
I know.
That is one stop.
I've played a lot of football in my day, and if that's not motivation right there,
I don't know
what it is, man.
So second down, and there he goes. That's going to be Ismael Cuevas gaining 6 yards. So that's going to bring up third and five.
Oh, man. Third and five. Well, they can definitely get five. That's pretty. We know that.
We know they can get 25.
Yeah, we know that they can run at will.
And so now this is really this game is going to come down to the offense. There goes the Ward.
Whoa!
There goes Landon Ward. First down for Wilcox. And he's going to pick up about 11 yards.
Brings up a first down.
Good gravy. 5 minutes left in the game.
He just jumped over a defensive end.
Yeah, that was cool.
I want that to be seen. He jumped over the defensive end. that is line pancaked for him.
Yep.
So it's going to be first and 10 for the Cowboys here. And they're handing it off to Remington Todd, and it looked like he almost fumbled again.
Oh, my gosh.
But he held on to the ball. That's a gain of 8, second and 2 now.
You got to wonder how he's, like, what, how does he hold the ball? Do you, so my thing was, my coach always told us, hold it high and tight. You want your fingers at your collarbone. You want to be touching your collarbone. You want to be running with that elbow swinging low. You don't want it out.
You always want that ball tucked 3 points of contact at least.
Yes.
And there goes Swayman's stiff arm. Down the middle, first down, Cowboys.
I mean, Scottsdale hasn't really had any fumbles. You kind of wonder. What are they? I mean, they are going after the ball. They're trying to strip the ball every time.
And so this is first and 10. Now they're in Spartan territory with 4 minutes, 15 seconds left on the clock.
Oh, my gosh. The drama. The drama.
And if Wilcox scores here, they have a chance to take the lead.
Yeah. And they've been running the ball at will. They just fumbled the ball inside the 23 times this game.
So the ball's going to Remington Todd, following his line. And he's going to get about 5. And he fumbled.
Nah.
Oh, they're saying he's down, he's down, he's down.
I'm looking at him run. Like you were saying, the 3 points of contact, he does not hold the ball.
He swings
well.
The ball out.
Yeah.
And that's something he's got
to
fix.
Yeah. Oh, man, someone's got to talk to him about that. If he's a junior, he needs to work on that in the off season because, like, his elbow comes out when he's carrying the ball. And he's doing that with his left arm, but not with his right arm, I'm also noticing. So I'm wondering if he's a righty that's holding the ball with his left hand.
And holding the ball high and tight is definitely important. And there goes Landon Ward. And that's a first down for the Cowboys.
Oh, the referee just took one. Good Lord.
We have an official down on the play.
I think everybody's celebrating now, unfortunately.
And it looked like he just got knocked over. He was not ready for that.
He's not a spring chicken.
And now he's telling them he's A-okay.
3 minutes left in the game. I don't know why they stopped the clock. Oh, for the referee. Okay. Well.
So there's 3 minutes, 12 seconds left. Scottsdale prep on top, 27-21 right now.
Yep.
And they're going to check and make sure this ref is A-okay to finish calling this game.
I think he'll be fine.
I think so, too. I mean, he just doesn't have any protection on his head.
I know.
And that's the biggest concern.
Yep. Yeah, you wonder.
So it looks like he's good.
Yeah, he's good. No head injury.
Perfect.
He had a handlebar mustache. That kept him safe. That's what I think.
Oh, yeah, the mustache gave him all the cushion he needed.
Better than the helmet.
So now there's 3 minutes on the clock. Wilcox has the ball in Scottsdale territory. First down.
Jeez,
tuck that ball. Hold that ball. Remington Todd getting the first down.
Man, I'm not sure I'm tossing the ball. Like, you got to make sure you've got no attitude. Make sure that they don't take offense to anything. Tossing the ball is like right on the edge. Right on the edge. Like, I wouldn't call a penalty on it, but if they don't like you, they will. And you don't want to give them that opportunity.
So it's first and 10 from the 23-yard line.
Oh, no.
And the snap is fumbled. Just fall on it.
I know. You're totally right. Why is he trying to pick that ball up? That was going
to
be a handoff.
Just fall on the ball and just keep it controlled. Keep it controlled.
You dive on that ball, you don't lose as much yardage.
And so there's a timeout. And so this timeout is going to be brought to you by the Marathon Truck Stop Willcox Express Store. Proudly supporting and sponsoring all of Willcox and their youth. Stop by and see Robin, Michelle, Marie, and Carlos. Mention you heard it in Cool FM and receive a free 22-ounce fountain drink and or coffee.
Get those legs warm. Do your push-ups. You're on the sidelines.
And I feel terrible for the sideline right now.
Dude.
Some of these kids don't even have sleeves on.
I know. That's ridiculous. I'm from cold weather. I wouldn't do that.
So it's second and 20.
Yeah.
Second and 18. Willcox needs a first down, or they need to score.
Are they going to throw the ball?
I hope not.
I hope not, too. I definitely...
So it's going to be second and 18. Give it to the warden. And there goes the warden.
Jeez.
Doing what he does.
Getting it back.
And now it's a doable third down.
Are you kidding me? Third and 10? He got... Oh, wow.
Now it's a doable third down.
Yeah, third and 12. He can totally do it.
And they knew what they were up against this week. Scottsdale Prep knew who they were facing this week. Landon Ward.
They're going to the two-minute warning tied. Oh, they don't call a timeout at the two-minute warning. Weird. Wow. No.
So now there's 1:50 left in the fourth quarter. Willcox down 21-27. And it's fumbled.
Fumble on the play.
And Scottsdale Prep gets the fumble.
It's been fumbles all night.
And that's the killer for Willcox.
Yep.
Is the fumbles.
Oh my gosh. They had this game won. They had this game won. Multiple times they've lost this via fumble. You just, heartbreaking. Golly.
And that's a tough, tough play for Willcox.
And the other team, Scottsdale Prep, has not fumbled once. Or I don't think they have.
And I want to see if they're going to just knee out this clock.
I think they... What's going on here? A penalty. Oh, they didn't get him off the field in time.
We have a dead ball, illegal substitution on the offense.
Yeah.
Illegal substitution on the offense.
Yeah. And he's out there crying. That's unfortunate. He's an asshole. I've been watching him. He wanders around on the sideline, winding up. Oh, golly. Not my kind of teammate.
So Willcox.
Willcox playing defense.
Tough blow for Willcox.
They still have all three timeouts, so they could stop it right here.
Tough blow for Willcox.
Oh, big loss. Jeez.
So Willcox gets a stop. They're going to call a timeout.
Okay. So let's play this out. They lose another two. So, because I think they're just going to keep running the ball. Let's just say they don't lose any more yards and it's fourth and 14 and they're punting. Block kick? Are we looking at a block punt?
I think Willcox will try to block the punt if it comes down to them punting.
Oh, I think it will. I think their defense is just fine.
So I think Willcox could try to block this punt. And that'll make a huge difference. Whether Willcox's defense right now has the entire season in their hands. They have their entire season in their hands right
now.
Score
is 27-21. Not 28-21, but 27. But thank you for doing that, Justin. We really appreciate it. All right.
So here comes the Willcox Cowboys defense. And they're going to need a stop here.
Wow, they're lining up in a run offense. Oh, come on.
And that's going to be an offsides on the defense.
Yep. Jeez.
And now they're going to get some of the yards gained back on the loss.
Yep.
So now it's second and 15 instead of second and 20.
Right. Still time on the clock. You know, they still have a chance here.
Now Scottsdale Prep is working behind the sticks with a minute 30 left to go. But Willcox has an offense that could probably still score right here.
Yeah, I mean, they could strip the ball, fumble.
So they stopped him in the middle. So now it's going to be third and 11.
Yeah.
Third and 12. Willcox calls a timeout. That's going to bring up third down.
Yeah.
So now there's third down and fourth down. And I don't know what you do if you're Scottsdale Prep here. I don't know if you go for it and give it to them in your territory and try to risk getting the first down, or if you punt it and sure shot give Willcox the ball back knowing that they can score.
I think you punt.
Because Willcox will just try to bring everybody.
Oh, they will.
And go block that.
Yep.
And I think that's Wilcox's really best option here.
Yeah. I mean, Scottsdale could run a max protect possibly, but I mean, with as much penetration as they've been getting on those kicks, on the extra points, you can't really assume that Scottsdale's actually going to get it to the punter.
Or we could see a fake punt like Wilcox.
Oh, golly. That's right, yeah. There's only a minute 31 left in the game. Score is 27-21.
So Wilcox's defense is going to have to step up big here. And that's a false start on the offense.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
False start on the offense.
Another penalty.
And that's going to make this a little harder.
I'm going to assume that none of these people are cold. All these penalties. Shout out to the cheer squad. Yeah, they've been great. Let's see if we, well, on the next play, I'll try and show them. Right now, they're standing in front of the away visitor stands. All right, they're lined up for another run.
So now it's third and 16. And Wilcox is going to have to defend this very well. And they will.
Wow.
This is going to be fourth down. Fourth down. They're going to run this clock. Let the clock run. Yep. Scottsdale Prep. And then they're going to punt.
Yep. They'll probably even call a timeout as the clock runs down. 1 second left on the play clock.
So now Wilcox is going to have to be alert to where their sidelines are.
Yep. And they've got, who are the returners? They got Ward and number 13.
So it looks like there's a lot of confusion on the Scottsdale Prep sideline on what they're going to do.
47 seconds and running.
And they're going to take this delay of game.
Yep. Oh, man.
And I think this is probably one of the smartest ways I've ever seen a coach waste time.
30 seconds left in the game and clock is running.
Time now out. They're going to get a fresh play clock. Play clock. They're going to get a fresh play clock.
But they'll get a fresh play clock. That's right. The clock will be stopped at 28 seconds with the score 27-21. Wilcox will get the ball back. No timeouts.
So now Wilcox is going to, if they want a chance to win this game, they're going to have to take this punt return more than likely for a touchdown.
Yep. Yeah, pretty much. Or they'll have to get their passing game figured out. Who knows?
Wilcox's season is on the line right here on this play.
Yeah. All right. Scottsdale Prep, max protect punt. They've got one person out as an axe man. Number 11 out there. In case. Oh, yeah, you got to put one person on him. And it looks like they got the block punt unit out there. Oh, no, it doesn't look like they're going to try and block it. Looks like this is max blocking.
They're going to let Landon Ward or Remington Todd take this back and put the season in their hands right here. And that's a solid punt. And Todd's going to get out of bounds. 19 seconds on the clock. Wilcox down by 6. And this first down and final Wilcox drive is going to be brought to you by TNB Tire Service Wilcox. We specialize in tire sales, tire repairs for passenger vehicles, semis, and farm equipment. Over 45 years of experience. Come down and see Mark Teeters at 2060 North Haskell Avenue for all your tire needs. And Big Tex Barbecue, always proud to support our young Cowboy athletes and all they do. We are so proud of you from Big Tex Barbecue, Wilcox. And this is what it's going to come down to, the final drive of the game.
Yep. All right. Everybody in the stands is on their feet right now.
And this is first down, 19 seconds left in this game. The toss to Ward. And Ward's gonna pass it to Todd out of bounds.
Oh,
and he goes out of bounds. And it looked like he just tossed the ball out of bounds. I was like a little confused. Yeah, but that's going to be first down.
Okay.
12 no, that's seconds. Not going to be first down.
Yeah, it looked like eight. They're saying, oh, 12 seconds left in the game. What's going
to
happen, baby?
Tried to pull out a trick play. They thought they would bite him deep.
Yep.
And then the DBs were very disciplined and stayed up. So here comes the Cowboys.
Incomplete, 9 seconds left.
And so they're running these quick plays.
Yeah.
So they've got 9 seconds left in the game. And that's gonna be a timeout.
Oh, jeez. Why would you call a timeout?
There's an injured player. And it's the same player that went down with the knee injury earlier.
He's telling them to get off the field. Because they...
The same player that went down with the knee injury earlier.
Just goes to show you don't need to lay down on the field all day long to get off when you're injured.
So this is third down, 9 seconds left in this game.
This is it. This is, if this isn't the last play, it's the second to last. One way or the other.
So here we go. They're looking deep. Remington Todd. And he throws a deep shot to Landon Ward, and it's intercepted. And that's going to be the end of Wilcox's season.
Yep. Great game, though. Great game. Scottsdale.
And there's a flag.
Oh, no. You got to wonder if that's going to affect their next game, though.
He spiked the ball straight into the floor.
Yeah. Well, that's the end of the game. We would like to thank all of our sponsors. Thank you guys so much for checking in. Everybody from Willcox. We'll do a quick little rundown of everybody, but we don't need to read everything.
Mills Tire and Tech, family owned since 2010 in Willcox. Brian Mills does everything, tires, auto work, engines, and has a love and passion for diesels. SSVEC, Sulphur Springs Valley Electric Cooperative, serving our community. The Ed Morse Automotive Group, formerly Lawely Automotive, now serving Cochise County. Stop in today and experience the difference. Cochise County is now backed by Morse. Bowie Pecans, the pecan farm that I kept saying the name of wrong, but a huge shout out to Bowie Pecans. Willcox Livestock Auction, Arizona's oldest livestock auction, serving Arizona and southwestern New Mexico. Marathon Truck Stop, Willcox Express Store. Mention you heard it in a Cool FM and receive a free 22-ounce fountain drink or coffee. Proudly supporting and sponsoring all of Willcox and their youth. TMB Tire Service Willcox, specializing in tire sales and tire repairs from passenger vehicles, semis, and farm equipment. Over 45 years of experience. Come down and see Mark Teeters at 2060 North Haskell Avenue for all your tire needs. And last but not least, Big Tex Barbecue, always proud to support our young Cowboy athletes and all they do. We are so proud of you from Big Tex Barbecue Willcox. And that's going to be the end of Willcox's season. This is Logan Seely and John live from Scottsdale Prep as the Scottsdale Prep Spartans take a 27-21 win over the Willcox Cowboys in Scottsdale tonight.
Oh, what an interesting game. God bless you all. Hopefully everybody has a great ride home. Be safe. Be warm. We love you, Cochise County. We'll see you later.